everyone, and welcome to Aristocrats, the weekly show set in a world where adventure awaits any worthy hero. But not these guys. These guys are going to be going on the quest that nobody else would touch with a 10-foot pole axe. We've got some awesome guests playing with us today. Mary Holland.
Hello.
Shalia Evans.
Hello.
And Zach Bornstein.
Hi,
guys. And I'm your host and DM, Clay Larson. If you guys are... No, please, you don't have to. They got when I said they don't have to that I wanted more. Nope, now it's too much. Guys, if you are watching on Twitch and you want to vote on things that will affect the show as we go on, you can watch us on jash.com/play. The Twitch stream will keep going there, and you can vote on things there, like the question that is up right now. I'm not going to say it out loud, so these guys don't know what we're voting on, but it will affect the campaign that we're about to do. Guys, why don't you just tell us a little bit real fast as we go down. You can have the inner piece.
I love snacks.
Why don't you guys each tell us real fast who you are, like what you do, and then also what character you're playing and anything you want to tell us about the character.
Okay. Yeah, I'll start. My name is Mary Holland. I am an actor and an improviser and a comedian and a cat lover and a friend to ghosts. And I am playing Jennifer Love Hewitt, who is a centaur and also an enchanter. And I'm just so excited. I think that, you know, we had this discussion before of if my character is wearing any clothes, and I think she's not. Mm-hmm. I think she's just going half horse body, topless, long hair, just, you know, your standard centaur look.
Right.
Yeah.
Very nice. I'm Shalia, and I'm playing Shalia. We'll get to that in a second. As a person that isn't the imaginary Shalia, so real Shalia, is like an actor and comedian and stuff. And then fake Shalia in the game is a priestess. She's a high elf woodwife. And I've chosen to stick with my real name because it's just as made up sounding as anything that could be in a fantasy story.
Now, what god are you a cleric of?
Of Shalia.
So Shalia playing the character Shalia, cleric of
Shalia. Yes.
Great.
Yes.
Cool. Not confusing
at all. Makes a lot of sense. I'll respond to anything with a shh.
And Shalia, real Shalia, is joining us for our second time. So at the end of the show, you guys can vote on if she should level up to level 2.
So, Mom.
She'll make an appeal at the end of the show to fight so you guys can decide.
Come on, Mom.
Which camera?
Over there.
Oh, okay. I just have to get the gray on my... I'm so sorry. I'm Zach. I'm a writer and a director and a comedian. And today I'm Steve Computer. I'm a changeling bard, so I can shift into things. I'm a bard, so I'm very very charismatic, but I'm very weak. And I have a lot of rations and a lot of candles with me. Mm-hmm. And I'm really looking forward to this.
Is a bard a musician?
Can be. I think a bard is kind of like a traveling entertainer, so he can be more of a musician, an actor, orator.
One who dazzles.
One who dazzles.
Oh, the dictionary definition.
That is the all right, guys, let's get started. So you guys find yourselves at the beginning of the day. It's around 9 a.m. You are in the city of Calmstone, in the waiting room of the offices of Tavlin's Temporium, LLC, an adventuring temp agency in the city that you guys are working for. And you're waiting in the waiting room for Tavlin to come out and give you your temp job for the day. Okay. You're seeing you're in a white-walled room. There's, like, cheap plaid pattern armchairs, some old posters on the wall. There's cheap coffee in a corner.
How did we sleep?
You tell me, how did you all sleep?
Oh, all right.
I slept very well.
I had a ton of ZQL at like 2 a.m., so I just had no dreams and woke up at 10.
Oh, yeah, great. Just normal nights.
There's also a receptionist desk where Tavlin's receptionist, Betsy, is currently working on some paperwork.
And how did she sleep?
Betsy, do you want to ask her?
Yes.
Use your charm.
Hey, Betsy. How'd you sleep?
She doesn't even look up at you. She just, well, her head is still on her paperwork. Mm-hmm. Fine, Tavlin will be with you in a moment.
All right. What does she look like?
She's like a middle-aged lady, getting up there a little in middle-aged, but she's not old. She does have a sign, as has been established in many other shows, a sign next to her desk that is now, used to be printed, is now made out of macaroni that just says, I am 37.
And is that her age?
No one's ever actually asked her that.
Ooh, ask her.
Hey, Betsy. Is Betsy right? No, I shouldn't ask.
That's probably for the best. That's kind of rude, I guess. Oh.
Yeah, I guess so.
I can be a 19 charmer, but that's just rude.
So do you guys do anything else while you're out here?
Can I have some of the coffee?
Yeah. Mm.
Okay, great. Is it still caffeinated? Like,
it's definitely
it's
still
stale.
Yeah, it's not stale. It's just a little cold.
Okay, great.
I mean, it's not actually. It's probably lukewarm. It's not cold.
Okay, okay. So I'm gonna have some of that.
Yeah, you can get a little paper cup of coffee. Sure.
Great.
You want sugar? Because there is some there.
I'll have some sugar. Yeah.
Okay.
I'll just have a sugar packet.
Just a sugar packet?
Yeah.
Just gonna like put it on your tongue.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, you can do that.
Thank you.
You guys do not have to roll to drink coffee.
Okay.
Can I use my message spell?
To who?
To Betsy.
Sure.
Okay, so I can point at her and just whisper anything?
Yep.
Okay.
And only she will hear it.
Okay, should I say it out loud or just to you?
Say it out loud. You guys can't hear this.
Okay. Oh,
okay. Betsy, Steve Computer here. I don't want to ask in front of everyone because I know it might be awkward, but as a group, we were wondering how old you were because we saw your sign, and I just wanted to be able to ask you in the most tactful way possible. So just hold up fingers like this. For decades, and then for which year in that decade. And I won't tell anyone.
So you guys, in-game, were just, like, getting your coffee.
Coffee,
you
yeah.
yeah. And Betsy, like, looks up and looks over at Steve and just, like, looks at him, says, I'm not going to talk about that with you.
Okay. Wow.
Tavlin will be with you in a moment.
Out of nowhere. Okay, that didn't really
go. She kind of,
well.
As she puts her head back down, she just kind of goes like, unbelievable.
My God, what did you do? What did you say?
I asked her age.
Oh, come on.
She already has that was rude.
No tact.
She has a sign out to stop that question.
So as you guys are admonishing Steve for asking Betsy about her age, the door to the inner office opens, and a fat little gnome starts waddling out. He's holding a manila envelope and wearing these, like, dark blue velvet robes, and he comes out and he says, greetings, adventurers! And this is Tavlin.
Hi, Tavlin.
Tavlin Crownbottom.
Hi, sir.
Today, I hope you're ready, you shall be served a main course of adventure with just a dollop of danger on the side. Mm. You will be heading to the Mancers Guild in the city center, where the Ursa Mancer Kalto Bergman has requested your assistance. It seems one of the Mancers, Kalto there, has a task for you. Oh, yes. Who knows what mysteries you may encounter in his employ?
Oh. You said so many things there, Tavlin. So I got Ursa Manson.
Ursa Mancer?
Damn it.
Ursa Mancer.
Kalto Bergman?
Kalto.
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 Is that like...
And we need to write these down.
Kalto.
You can, if you want to help help you remember.
No.
And Tavlin also hands one of you, whoever can take it.
I'll take it.
Okay.
Great.
It's the contract that has all the details of the job.
Okay.
And so it says, the person hiring you is the Ursa Mancer, Kalto Bergman.
Oh, Ursa Mancer.
That's a job.
Mm-hmm.
And is that something with a bear, right?
Yeah. You can assume that. Do you want to see if your character knows exactly what that is?
Yes.
So roll a d20 on, you're going to roll on Arcana.
Am I using up anything by doing this?
Nope.
Okay.
So roll your d20. And your character, Mary, is actually trained in Arcana.
17, sorry.
And you have a +5.
Okay.
So what do you get total?
I got 17 total.
And?
Or 17 plus 5. 22!
Oh.
22. So with the 22, yeah, you know enough about mancers to know that they are a type of wizard that specializes in one thing specifically. So okay. Like a pyromancer would be a magician who specializes in magic.
Oh, necromancer.
And necromancer specializes in
death.
The dead.
I thought that was all
and
one word.
Ursamancer.
Bears.
Specializes in bears.
Bear wizard. Bear wizard.
Mm-hmm. And the contract says that he is hiring you, but he doesn't say like what the task specifically is.
Mm. How did he hear about us?
He hired you through the Tavern's Temporium LLC. We put the adventurers that were most most appropriately deal with the tasks of a client and who happen to be available in contact with them.
Calvin, you're sweating. Are you okay?
I'm fine.
I didn't mean to put pressure on you by asking.
It's just a lot of people. Most people just take the job and go. They don't ask how our staffing procedures work.
Well, I just want to know if our social media presence mm-hmm. is... Or I don't know our presence,
our divine domain.
Yeah, what that presence is like. Anyway,
now you're all sweating.
How much are we making?
Yeah, that will depend on the expediency and quality of the task you complete.
Okay.
It seems to be a minimum of 10 gold each.
10 gold
each. 10 gold minimum.
What about overtime?
Love that 10 gold min.
Well, there shouldn't be overtime because, of course, as you know, our general rules are, in order to get paid, you must complete this contract by the close of day at 5:30 p.m.
Oh, great. Flat rate. Okay.
Yes.
Okay.
Let me see.
Should we go?
Is there a stipend?
There is no stipend!
Per diem?
No stipend.
Honestly, you are independent contractors, so I cannot stress enough, you are not actually hired by me. Person on the contract, in this case, Kelto Bergman, is your employer for the day.
Okay, well, we'll save receipts and just deal with that when tax time comes around.
Now, definitely save your receipts. I cannot stress that enough.
Save receipts. Write those off.
Is this 1099 or W-2?
This will be a 1099 with the city of Calmstone.
And now, do you want to join us?
No, I have to stay here.
Okay.
I have to prep all the other adventurers who will be coming in throughout the day for their temp jobs.
Okay.
Can I whisper?
Sure.
Come on, man, just join us. It'll be fun. Are you just hanging out here all
the time? Tavlin points back to you, and so you only hear this. Says like, please, I would prefer to use open channels of communication in the office. I find it rude to the other adventurers.
Okay.
You guys stared at each other for a while just now.
We're just hanging out.
Yeah.
Okay.
All right. Well,
thank you.
Thanks, Tavlin.
Bye, Tav.
Wonderful. And you know how to get to the Mancer's Guild.
No, we don't know how to get there.
Well, it's in the city center, and he describes, and it's basically in between Dock Ward and the Great Gray Hall of the Council of Mages and Adjuncts.
Great.
So in this area. So
you guys,
you guys know the city well enough that from his directions you can find it.
Great.
Okay.
Great. Is it walkable?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Yeah, you can definitely walk there, probably like 15 minutes.
Okay. Good neighborhood.
You guys...
Yeah, you're not going through Hex Row or anything.
Okay.
Like that.
Oh, thank God.
Why don't you guys hop on my back and we'll go?
That's so nice of you. Yes.
So just you know, a centaur is slightly smaller than a regular horse. So
I'll try to carry them for a while and then I'll ask them to get off.
Okay.
Get off my back.
We could also take turns if that helps.
You're a high elf and you're a changeling. Neither of those are huge. So yeah,
Can you turn into something smaller?
I could turn into the gnome to Tav.
Yeah, you could turn into Tavlin. Yeah.
I'd like to turn into Tavlin, please.
We haven't left the office.
So, in front of Tavlin, you shapeshift into Tavlin.
Does he become me?
No. So he's staring at you, and your clothes don't change, so they're much baggier now. Because a changeling is about the size of a normal human. I'm assuming you were in your normal shape at the beginning of this.
Yeah.
So your clothes are kind of baggy on you now.
I see.
And you look like, to you two, look like Tavlin.
Okay.
And Tavlin's staring at you and he goes, well, you didn't waste any time on that, did you?
I was just seeing if I could do it. Still remembered how it's been a while.
Really? It's been a while since you've shapeshifted.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, incredible.
Okay, I'm going to shapeshift back, so I'll stop.
Guys, I feel like we're wasting our time here.
Do you have any other questions, adventurers?
I think, anything you want us to say, hey, to Kaldo about? You got any messages or anything?
No, not really.
Great. Mm. Okay.
All right.
Have
a great day on your adventure.
Thanks, Tav.
Bye, Tav.
Thanks,
bye.
Boss.
Goodbye.
Goodbye.
And he goes back into the inner office.
Okay, great.
What a weirdo.
What? Betsy's still here. We have to leave for induction.
I don't think he should. He's our boss. I don't think he should.
Betsy, please don't tell Tavlin we just talked about him.
It's fine. I won't.
Thank you. You're the best.
And
Betsy.
We didn't. Steve Computer did.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah.
If you bring it up, just be specific.
Be clear.
So you guys head now?
Yeah, we'll head out.
So you leave the office.
Clip, clop, clip, clop, clip, clop, clip, clop.
Mary just does that for her character all the entire
out of her
show.
Mouth, not
yeah,
her
you
feet.
Don't actually make that sound.
It's a centaur that says clip, clop, clip, clop.
Clip, clop, clip, clop. Mm-hmm.
I shouldn't laugh so much. I don't know. Maybe that's part of the culture.
Mm-hmm. It is.
So you guys leave Tavlin's and you find yourselves on the streets of Calmstone. Say, for Calmstone, think of it as like a medieval metropolis, sort of like late 1700s, early 1800s, London-esque place.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Very nice.
And so it's like paved roads, a lot of carriages going by. Mm-hmm. It's not like insanely busy, but there's people and horses and everything going along on the street. Huh. So what do you want to do? You can go straight to the Mancer's Guild. You could, if you have errands you need to run, you can do that.
Get
if there's
some
anywhere
groceries
else.
Or something for the roads?
Sure.
Should
some
we go
snacks?
Go to TJ's?
Can
we go to Trader Joe's?
Trader Joe's. You want to find the trader known as Joe. Get some market you could look for him.
It's kind of off-brand.
Does he sell affordable but delicious snacks?
They're sort of affordable, but he kind of like tells a lot of stories about the places
no,
they
go
from.
No, we don't
want to
go there.
And it's sort of like, Joe, if they're really that exotic, how do you get these prices?
Yeah. I see that.
Interesting. Okay.
You know what? I could send someone later.
Okay, great.
We'll use the money that we make from today, and I'll have groceries delivered.
We'll splurge.
That's perfect.
Yeah.
That's great. Amazon Now.
Mm-hmm.
What do we see in front of us? I know you mentioned horses, but are there storefronts?
Where you are now, there's some other businesses. There's nothing like, no major, like very large storefronts.
Mm-hmm.
There's a lot of like apartments and there's like a stable at one end of the block. But there's not too much like particularly interesting things.
Should we get another horse for this mission?
I mean, you could go to a stable and try to rent one if you want.
And then you could ride it.
Oh, yeah.
Horse on horse.
Oh, boy.
you want to go pick up on some horses?
Yeah.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
It'll guess. It'll be fast.
I feel like we should just go straight to our man.
Yeah.
What do you guys think?
Yeah.
I don't know what... What should
we head over?
Let's head over.
Yeah.
We're good employees.
Yeah.
Okay. Sure.
We don't. Wait.
Oh.
What?
I don't know. I feel like. I don't know. I don't know if there's little secrets or treats that are waiting for us in the city center.
Should
there's
we?
So many, probably.
Is there any public transportation to get us there?
I mean, you could hail a carriage.
Hail a carriage.
That way we could get our horse fixed.
I'm going to be honest. There's a lot of places where it doesn't matter. It might be hard to get a centaur into a carriage.
Oh, wow.
Okay, here we go. All right. I get this all the time.
Centaur society we live in.
Yeah.
There should be ramps for
exactly.
them.
Exactly. It's really.
You know what? We
rude.
Can walk, I think.
Let's walk.
Let's
go.
Walk.
Here we go.
It's early in the morning. Is it hot out?
It's like 76.
Oh, okay. So it's getting a little warm, but
yeah.
not
and we're
so
carrying
warm,
a ton of stuff.
We have so much with
so
us.
Much.
We have
oh my
5
God.
Days worth of food on me.
And let me guess, I'm going to have to carry it.
Yeah.
Okay, great. Yeah. So we walk to the...
The Mancer's Guild?
The Mancer's Guild.
To the Mancer's Guild.
Cool. So you guys head there, and as you approach the city center, you start seeing a larger building come into view, and it's a tall guild hall.
Okay.
And as you start getting closer, you can see this is a very tall stone building that it has, and imagine a center spire, but then wings that come off of it that kind of spiral out from the center.
Ooh.
So if you were looking at it from the top, it would look almost like spiraling, like that, almost like...
Like a galaxy?
Kind of like a galaxy, yeah. And as you get closer, you guys don't, but Shalia, you kind of can see as you get closer to the building that those wings, because they appeared to all of you like they got smaller as they spiral out from the center. Mm. But as you get...
Like the Vietnam Memorial?
I'm not sure.
What is she talking about?
Go ahead.
As you get closer, you specifically notice that those wings, they get smaller as they go out, but then they also split into smaller wings off of the original wings, and it sort of fractals out.
Whoa.
Cool.
We don't notice this.
And why does
No, you guys don't know shit.
And do I give a shit, or?
I don't know, do you?
Oh, I think I'll, you know what, I'll comment on the on the architecture.
Okay.
Cool, guys, look. Those things get smaller and keep going.
Do you give a shit, though?
Honestly, I don't know, it's just like, it's not usually what you see. You know, it's unusual. So it's like extra effort for what purpose?
So you can see them, but we can't.
Hmm. Well, now that she's pointed it out,
now we can.
Like it's something that she just happened to notice, even though she was expressly looking for it.
Okay.
You guys were
just being observant. That's great.
Yeah, you just weren't quite as observant.
Okay.
I see.
So, cool. Should we? What do? Do we go into one of those?
Let's check
them out.
I mean, there's probably a ton of them, right? So we need to choose one.
Well, there's one main entrance in the center of the school.
That's purely decorative. Can I investigate if they're decorative?
Sure, if you want.
Do you guys mind if I check if they're decorative or functional?
No, can we come with?
Yes, please.
Oh, great.
Okay.
So you want to go and look
I'd like to go look at what are these fractioning wings and see if it's like a functional design or if it's just
aesthetic. Do an investigation check.
An investigation check.
So you're gonna roll your d20.
Great.
And I don't believe
you. Seems like a good use of my time.
You're gonna add your intelligence to that.
Okay. Well, I'm not that smart. Well, I got an 8 plus a 9, so that's 17.
Wait. Oh, no, it's a minus 1.
Minus 1. Oh, no. Wait, that's just where I'm starting?
Yeah.
God damn.
Now, can I investigate?
Sure.
No?
So, first, you can totally do that. So, first,
I failed to figure out if it's functional.
And you're looking at this, and you just see, like, huh, these stone things just keep going.
Cool. Neat, guys. Looks like it's just for show.
But you can investigate, too, if you'd like.
You know, I love you. I think you're so smart and
so
perceptive. I'm just going to double check because there might be something there.
All right.
That, you know, but I mean, look, I trust you. I totally.
It's fine.
You know, I'm just going to double check. We're just going to double check. It's not a thing.
It's fine. We have different, you know, we're different species. We have different eyes.
Exactly.
You might be able to see something I can't.
Different
see.
Points of view.
Yeah.
Here we go.
Can I whisper something to her very quickly?
Oh, my God.
Sure.
You handled that very well.
Really?
Very tactful.
Thank you so much.
You're very welcome.
That's really nice.
You're so nice.
I cast a friend spell on him.
Oh! You are so cool.
So you cast friends on someone who's already friends with you. And so
you're like the most cool.
You are much more, like, all of a sudden, the centaur is like, she is so cool, so great. And when the spell runs, which is going to end in about, like 30 seconds or so, 30 seconds to a minute, you will know that you've been charmed.
Oh, no. Okay. Okay, so here I go. I'm going to do the investigation.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. 10, and then plus 3, so 13.
13. So as you're looking at it, at first it kind of like looks the same way as what Shalee was describing. You're like, yeah, it just keep going off.
Yeah.
But you kind of notice As you look from where it comes off originally from the larger building and is much like a much larger wing of the building, as it gets smaller, you see that the windows, there were some windows like higher up than you could just look in, but there's windows near the top of the wing. And as it gets smaller and keeps fractaling out, mm-hmm. the windows change size too.
Okay. So, guys, the windows get smaller too.
What?
And when it splits off into other fractaling wings, mm-hmm.
yes.
you kind of notice that those also seem to have what appear to be tiny, tiny windows like the larger ones. Mm.
Okay, so they're little windows that are like the bigger ones. Do you think this means there are little creatures in there?
Oh, man.
I think of like progressive sizes.
Size mm-hmm. that have been assigned to their workplace based on their size.
Will we get assigned to our workplace based on our size? Because we're going to work there?
What? Yeah. Well, what do the windows mean?
Can I investigate?
Sure.
Can I try to, like, peer into one of them?
One of the larger ones or one of the smaller ones?
Smaller ones.
Okay. Go ahead and roll your
D20.
D20.
And we'll do this just as a perception, not a
what's the difference?
Investigation. You're just going to add your wisdom.
Okay. Plus zero.
None.
Eight.
Eight. So you're still able to see into it because you're just looking through a window. Mm-hmm. And it's sort of hard because it's small enough that it's kind of like hard to get a good view. But you think you see people walking by.
People? Are they are they proportional to the window or are they much bigger? Are they like our size?
You can't quite tell. It's hard to, like, you see people passing and it looks normal size in relation to the inside of wherever you're looking.
Mm-hmm.
But it's hard to tell. Like, it's a weird thing where, like, if you imagine looking through a keyhole, it looks sort of like that.
I see. Okay. Can my whisper thing go through the keyhole?
Sure.
Were you going to
try that?
No. Yours is reusable. This is like a big deal.
Oh, okay.
This is a big deal if I do.
Okay, I'm going to point through the keyhole and whisper at one of those people walking by.
So this is
what
to you guys. This is, as far as you can tell, this is someone. Imagine someone putting their finger up to a keyhole-sized window and just funk, and then just.
Okay. What are you doing?
What are you whispering?
I want to whisper to the guys walking by and say, what's going on in there? We're confused.
Mm-hmm.
Just a little insight. We're outside the window. Come chat.
So you don't hear anything back.
Okay.
Nobody stops?
Nobody responds to that if they did hear it. It's sort of hard because you can't really see who you're pointing at while you point.
Makes
so you're not
sense.
Even sure who may have received that message.
Okay.
But no one comes up to the window while you guys are waiting for that.
Okay. Sorry to waste your time.
No, it's okay.
At this point, one of the guards outside of the main entrance of the Mancer's Guild has like noticed you guys hanging out over by one of the sides on the grounds and comes over and says, can I help you?
It's a free country. I assume.
It is. This is slavers' country.
Oh no.
Is this a free country?
Oh,
okay.
A free country. Oh, thank God.
You were right. So, can I ask the guard a question?
Sure.
Sir. So, what's up with these tiny windows?
Oh, that's just one of the wings of the hall, of the guild hall.
And is it magically small, or does everyone get smaller that works there?
Sure. When you go in the guild, it's got so many wings that it's got a... basically, as you travel through the building, you won't detect that you're getting smaller, but it gets smaller as you go.
Oh, wonderful.
And what does that do?
Let's them fit a lot more mancers into...
Excuse me? Fiddle out more mancers?
Fit a lot more mancers.
Oh, fit a lot.
Yeah, you got all kinds of...
I thought you said fiddle out.
Not just pyromancers and necromancers in there.
I see.
Please excuse Jennifer Love Hewitt. She's been fiddled by a lot of mancers.
Oh, boy.
Listen. It's fine. I talk kind of fast, I've been told.
No, that's okay. Okay, so there's so you do that so that you can have more mancers in the building.
I'm just a guard. I didn't set this up. It's just how I understand the building works.
How did you sleep last night?
How did I sleep? Pretty well. No real dreams to speak of. I've been meaning to start a dream journal, but I never have gotten around to it, you know?
We gotta get out of here.
Yeah. I'm gonna use a minor illusion. I'm gonna throw some gunshots, just the sound, a couple wings down.
Uh-huh. On the outside of the building still?
Yeah.
Okay. And you're...
Punch sounds.
Punch sounding gunshots.
Yeah. That's what I meant. That's better.
Like a punch, like someone's getting beat up.
And someone going, help, guard.
And he looks at him. Let me see. He believes that is real. So he says excuse me, folks, I gotta go check that out. And he runs off.
Nice work.
Good move.
God, he was gonna go into his dream journal. Oh my God, where did that come from?
It's one of your 5 days of rations.
You haven't even started the journey.
Oh, mark off a day of rations for yourself.
Nothing makes you hungrier than casting a minor illusion spell.
Oh man.
So the guard has left, and he gave you basically that explanation about the wings get smaller as you walk through them.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. So it's a perspective thing. It's it's a trick. Trick of the mind.
Like an Escher.
Well, it's magical.
Yeah, it's like being in a magic Escher.
Mm-hmm.
Should we go in? We should go in.
Well,
should we go in?
Do you want to finish your banana?
No, I can walk in with it.
Okay. So let's go. Let's head to the front door with the banana.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and he drops the peel, and I skid on it a little bit.
Okay. Roll it. So you step on the peel.
Yeah, but in a funny way.
Oh, so you're sitting on it in purpose.
Yeah. I'm doing a bit.
Great. So
I'm like Jennifer Love Hewitt's funny.
Here's what's great. You are gonna have to roll to make sure you don't you step on a banana and you can start as a bit, but sometimes then you accidentally start.
It's too dangerous.
I break a leg, I'll have to be put down.
But because you're a centaur,
yeah,
you have advantage on anything that would knock you down.
Okay.
Because you have,
extra legs.
So you're gonna roll your d20 for a dexterity check, you're going to you have advantage, so you're gonna roll the d20 twice and use the higher number.
Okay. Mm. That's a
six.
Plus
two, so eight.
Come on. This was all just a joke. Not worth it.
It's all for the bit.
No.
Eight.
Is that? What happens to me?
You kind of start doing, you don't hurt yourself. You start doing this as a joke, kind of making eyes at them, I'm going to fall. And then you kind of you do lose your balance a little and go down. You know how horses will go, if they're going to lay down, they'll go down on their front legs first?
Yeah.
You end up with just your front legs down like that.
Okay.
And have to kind of embarrassingly
yeah. Okay, and I should act that out right now? Okay. Hey, guys, watch.
Ten.
Jeez.
Was it really worth it?
No.
Can I whisper something to Shalia? Yeah. What a doofus.
And then I'm going to cast another friend spell on him.
Oh, that was awesome. What a good bit.
Great. So your bit has succeeded with Steve Computer. So you guys head in?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, let's head in. Should we help you up? Do you need help or you got it?
Can we help you up?
I would like some help if you don't mind.
There you go.
Okay, I'm up.
Okay.
Great. So you guys go into the Mancer's Guild, and in this main entrance hall, there are mages of all different races, creeds, just bustling around. It's a very busy entrance. There's a large pedestal in the middle with a large book open on it, right in the center of this area. And then around it, there appear to be eight different large archways leading off to what you can tell pretty easily would seem to correspond to those wings you saw coming out.
Okay.
Okay. So this is probably the directory.
Mm-hmm. Oh yes.
For the building.
Yeah, that makes sense.
Can we go look in that book?
Yeah.
Great.
Yeah, and if you get out there, there's a little plaque on it mm-hmm. that says the Big Book of Mancers.
Oh. Oh.
So we're looking for the Ursa.
So yeah, yeah. Ursa.
Ursa Mancer. Kalto Bergman.
Yeah, that was the name.
Yeah.
So yeah, as you go through, there are just a huge number of Mancers, and they are categorized by the 8 schools of magic.
Oh, okay.
There's illusion, enchantment, alteration, divination, invocation, necromancy, abjuration, and conjuration.
Which,
conjuration, you find Ursamancer under conjuration.
Oh, conjuration.
Conjuration.
And it tells you to go through the conjuration hall, and it's office number
324. All right.
And there's people bustling around going into all the different ones?
Yeah, people are going to and from all of them.
Which one looks like the most interesting?
There's a lot of people going. There's not a ton of people going to necromancy, although there are a decent amount, and a lot of the people who are going do seem to be like doctors, because necromancy is not just to do with the dead, but it's life and death.
Mm-hmm.
So there's like a lot of like doctors going there. Out of the others, probably I think invocation is having the most traffic today.
Is it, they have a conference or something?
I don't think it's a conference, but it's one of the more for adventurers practical schools of magic. Like a lot of like fireballs would be.
Do they do lectures here?
Does who do lectures?
Do they have lectures?
Oh, do they have lectures?
Yeah.
Yeah, they sometimes do.
Cool.
They'll have occasional lectures.
Free to the public, or you have to pay?
There is a membership program for the Mancer's Guild.
Oh, sorry. Here we go.
I have 10 gold.
Get looped in
there. There is a kiosk one to one side if you want to, that has a big sign that says, sign up for Mancer membership.
Do not do it.
No.
I was going to.
No. Save your money.
You'll never be able to subscribe from the
email
list. All right. What were the other ones?
The schools of magic?
Yeah.
Illusion, enchantment, conjuration, abjuration.
What is that one?
Abjuration is like protection.
Mm.
Like a shield spell would be abjuration.
Mm.
If we go into one of these schools of magic, can we pick up a couple extra spells or skills?
Mm. I mean, you'd probably have to spend a long time, like at least the rest of... Like, at least probably 4 to 6 hours. Like,
oh, geez.
You know, studying, scribing a spell into your spell book.
Is there a clock in here?
There is a large magical clock. It seems to be an illusion. It is right over the entrance to the illusion hall. But it appears to be like, almost like if you imagine the sparkling outline of a clock.
Ooh, I can do that. Yeah.
That's cool.
Great. What time is it?
Yeah.
At this point, it's just about 10.
Okay. We don't have time to learn a magical trade.
Is there a cafe?
There's no cafe inside.
You just ate a banana.
You just ate a lion. You're carrying 4 days of food.
Please. Do you
I'm carrying
it. Do you guys have anything without carbs?
No.
No, I think we need to...
I just carry bread.
We need to police your... I just have oats.
Oh, damn it.
All right.
Yeah. I just
all
have
carbs over here.
What? You need something to mix it in.
Yeah, well...
Should we just go do the work?
Yeah, let's go into the
Well, here's the thing. We don't even know what the job is yet.
No.
This guy's just telling us what our job is.
Yeah, so we need to go.
We might have to go somewhere entirely different. So we should probably go bug him.
Here we go.
Can we just stop a guy who's walking past?
Sure. So like, you just want to like kind of say, like, excuse me.
Yeah.
So a dwarf is walking past.
Okay.
And he's just the first person.
sorry to bother you. Have you been down the hallway, any of these hallways before?
Yes, I've been down most of them.
You get small as you go down them?
Well, it's a magical effect. It's but in relation to where you are at.
It wears off when you come back out.
Yes, the wind, you can't actually leave through the windows. They're magically enchanted to only let light through. It'd be very difficult to go out that way.
Have you tried leaving through the windows?
Well, I don't know how else you would be worried about
not coming back out the way you came.
He's insecure about his size already.
Very weak.
So he doesn't want
to come back smaller.
The further you go, the smaller you get to match the size of the offices you'll be going to. And then when you come back out, you proportionally will match the size as you come back out. By the time you leave this hall, you'll be back to your normal size.
Great. Great.
Nothing to worry about.
Great.
The spell was woven into the very fabric of the stone when it was built. Mm.
And how did you sleep last night?
How did I sleep last night?
Well, he kind of like checks a little like, a little, not a watch, but it's like a steampunky type watch. Ugh. He kind of checks it and says like, I guess I do have a couple minutes.
No, I think we're okay. No,
yeah, we're fine, thanks.
Can I do a minor illusion, please? And he's like, all dwarves to the necromancy wing.
He looks up very puzzled. He immediately looks at you and says, like, well, you're just casting a minor illusion spell.
Can we just bolt?
Sure.
Yeah, let's just
run. We bolt.
He doesn't try to chase you because he's more confused by what that was.
So we go down the conjuration.
Okay.
Wing.
So you're going down and you're seeing all these offices, various places.
Looking for 324.
Yeah, and there's a lot of different types. There's arachnomancy.
Ooh,
What else would be in this hall? Taxomancy, financiomancy.
Financiomancy.
That sounds forced.
There's a variety of different. It seems like to be, as you get to points where like the hall itself starts fracturing off into other ones, seems to be a little bit like the deeper you get, the more specific the hall becomes. So like at one point it goes over and it's like, oh, this seems to be about where you're heading is like all about conjuring animals. And
okay.
Stuff like that.
Okay.
And one is
well-designed building.
What was that?
Well-designed building.
Yeah. I thought so.
Can you undo that comment?
So as you go, you eventually get yourself to the Ursomancy department.
Okay. Great.
And at that point, you're a couple branches in. So when you open, or you're in front of the door, right? Are you gonna just go in?
Well, we'll knock.
Yeah.
And a voice calls out, says like, "Enter."
Great. So now
we're like Tavlin. Is it
Tavlin? It's a different guy. It's a different guy.
Different guy.
Great. We'll come on in.
Yeah. And it's this one is not like a huge department. Mm-hmm. It's more like a medium to large size office that also has a workshop area on it. As you go in, you guys find a disheveled looking elf who's like definitely like fretting about. He looks a little bit like his hair's a mess, and he's wearing like some robes that are like not disgusting, but just look like he's been, like, they're a little dirty and, what was that?
A little stinky.
Like, he's
not
poor.
Even stinky, but, like, if he spends his time, like, outdoors a lot.
Okay. Outdoorsy elf.
Yeah. And he's bustling about in the workshop, and he looks up excitedly as you come in.
Oh.
And he kind of says, like, yes. Are you from the temp agency?
Oh,
yes.
Yeah. Yes, we are.
Good. Yes, we must be off immediately. Yes, to the Lingering Woods we're heading.
Lingering Woods.
Do you have any questions?
What? Yeah, go ahead.
Oh, what's your name?
Oh, I'm so sorry. Kelso Bergman, at your service.
God, great. You are our contact.
Are you Swedish?
Am I Swedish?
Well, we were just talking about
that. Are you Jewish?
No.
Bergman? What is...
It's
your lineage.
My lineage is elf. High elf.
Uh-huh.
Oh, I'm high elf.
Oh, my God.
I'm a
high
are
elf.
Are you single?
I'm not. Hold on. I'm a cleric. I'm committed to my god.
Right.
Which god is that?
Shalia. I'm Shalia.
Nice to meet you. And you are?
I'm Jennifer Love Hewitt.
Is that one name or?
Yeah. It's all one word.
Jennifer Love Hewitt.
Yeah.
And
Steve Computer. Nice to meet you.
Do you do point?
That's very charming.
Well, yes, wonderful to meet you. I'm supposing that you were not filled in on what's happening exactly.
No. No.
Okay.
No, just to come check with you.
Yes, I suppose you'd like to know what this is all about, of course. Well, I'm sorry.
No, I'm sorry.
I just... My attitude towards temp work is shining through.
Well, it's tough. It's a demanding job.
It's not hard thing.
Pay.
You know, it's not our calling.
Yeah,
it's just a survival
really
thing.
Tough.
You know.
Anyway.
Well, I mean, you are adventurers, correct?
Yes.
Absolutely.
Oh, yes.
Absolutely.
We
love
we want to be adventurers.
Well, totally.
You, how much adventuring have you... I was told that this particular temp agency was putting me in contact with experienced seasoned veterans.
Oh yeah, no, we're
absolutely,
we're definitely qualified.
He looks
whatever.
A little worried.
I go on an adventure every day.
Yeah,
you know?
Every day is an adventure.
Every day, and that's right. That's how you should look at life.
Yeah.
Oh,
can I create a minor illusion?
That's a warning statement. What are you doing?
Can I create a resume that shows all of our adventures listed on
yes.
it and hand it to him?
Yes, yes, yes.
So I'll tell you this: you can create it and show it to him. If you try to hand it, it's just, his hand's gonna go right through it.
Oh, here, I'll hold it for you.
Okay.
I'll let you look.
You keep a list of your adventures with you
and
at all.
And I'll cast a friend spell.
Okay.
You think we're really
and
cool.
Just in case.
Push friend.
No, I'll leave it. You know what? You know what? Let's see how those work first. I got a backup plan.
So you cast the minor illusion. You cast a friend spell, so he's immediately, like, much more jovial towards you.
Oh, it's only for me. It's not... Oh.
Wow. Oh, it's so good to see you.
Oh, thank you.
Oh, okay, yes. Could I see that for... Well, all right. I suppose you only have one copy then. And he's, like, much more interested in you
right
now. So
okay.
He kind of... Yes, good, good.
Yeah, so that's all our stuff. So we're adventurers, yeah.
Well, excellent. I'm mm-hmm. sure I can take your word for it.
Uh-huh.
Okay.
What a sweetie.
Well, it seems I made a little bit of a mistake.
Oh, come on.
Well, we need to get out to the Lingering Woods. I was experimenting with some of the local bear population, typical Ursamancy, and, well... Have you ever wondered what would happen if you tried to conjure and magically summon too many bears to the exact same location?
Yes.
You've wondered that.
Yes.
I was wondering the same thing.
Mm-hmm.
So I tried it, and it seemed, it's rather interesting, actually. The fabric of reality wants to make things right, and so it seemed to combine them all.
No mega bear.
Oh.
It tries to make one out of the many. It's very interesting, though. I haven't encountered this type of bear before. I actually named it.
What did you name it?
An ursipede.
Ursipede.
How many?
Hmm?
How many?
How many? One ursipede.
How many bear in ursipede? How many bears...
Is it like a Frankenstein situation where it's a bunch of legs and a bunch of bear heads, or is it just one giant bear?
That's what you would expect, but actually, it seems that, I don't know if it's a function of the magical principles in the world, but it wanted to create as much of a creature that could exist, so it's just one bear head. Many, 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 many bear legs.
Oh. Oh. Is it long like
about
a centipede?
About 100 feet.
Oh,
God.
God.
What kind of bear were you summoning?
Or polar bears.
Polar bears? Oh, my God.
Cut it in half, right?
Yeah.
Well, what are the...
I mean, I don't know. I'm just...
Well, no,
guys,
you don't need... please
what
don't
you,
cut it in half.
What, do you want him captured, killed? What are we talking here, man?
Well, he does need to be stopped, certainly.
Stopped?
Because
what's he doing?
He is... rampaging throughout.
Oh,
no, rampaging bear.
However, I do have this, and he goes to his workbench that he was at,
mm-hmm.
and he pulls up a potion. This is a potion of dispelling. Now, by my theory, if we're able to get the ursipede to drink this potion, it should disassemble into its component bears.
And that would be bad too, right?
There'd be so many bears.
There'd be a lot of bears.
It seems like it'd be easier just to kill the one ursipede.
Well, I just hate to kill a bear. They're so beautiful.
Well, sure, but...
Capture it?
Look, I would just really love it if we could find a way to do that. I understand. We may have to kill it.
We may. But I can also, look, I'm very good with animals.
Oh, yeah, you could speak
to it. So I can do what I can to try to befriend and chat with the Urzipede.
Sure, we could try that.
Oh, okay. All right. You know, you hired us. So.
I can't stress enough. The Urzipede is a fascinating creature. It's also a horrifying abomination.
Yes.
Right.
Was this like a human centipede thing that you did on purpose and now you're trying to pass it off as a mistake?
No, not on purpose. I didn't know what was going to happen if I summoned 100 or so bears into the same point.
But the bears, they don't have their mouths on each other's like butts.
No, again, can't stress enough, one bear head.
Okay. One bear head, lots of bear legs. Polar bear neck?
Hmm? Still the neck or just like...
Yes, leg? Imagine if you took a regular bear, like here, and he's got a lot of images of bears.
I would imagine. Yeah,
he points at an image. Imagine, and he like takes the middle segment of the bear and says, imagine if you took a normal bear and from here on its midpoint, stretched it out and all that extra space had bear legs, like the front legs coming out.
So just a bear centipede. Thus,
an Urzipede.
Yeah.
Can it stand on its hind legs?
You know me.
Be like 100 feet tall.
Fascinating. Maybe it could.
Like that, and it goes like that.
When it's trying to scare prey or scare what it deems as a threat.
I have to say, I'm a little.
Maybe we'll find out, eh?
I'm a little concerned based on what I know about polar bears that it's getting hot today. It's a pretty hot day.
Oh. Well.
Is it gonna get angrier as the day goes on?
Don't know if it could be angrier than it already is.
Oh, no, all right, okay. Oh, boy.
So should we go? We should hit the road, huh?
We should probably head out.
Okay.
I'll be coming with you. It's probably slightly being driven a bit mad by its predicament.
Oh, Jesus.
I'm not 100% sure what all the psyches of the bears, if they're battling, if one takes over. There's a lot of aspects to this that we're not sure of because, of course, this is the first recorded incident of an Urzipede.
Mm-hmm. So you're just allowed to do whatever you want as an Ursa.
Yeah, what are the checks and balances for your job?
I was studying the effects of bringing this many bears in one point.
You just do whatever you want.
Where do you get your funding?
Who do you report to?
Oh, do you really want to go into the complex administrative structures of the Mancer's Guild?
I mean, not really, but if we're going to get dragged into this legally, I feel like we should know.
Well, you weren't there for the initial thing.
That's so true. Of course, that's
any
true.
Experiments would be null and void if any disciplinary actions came into play.
Okay.
But let's be honest.
All right.
We're going to clean this up. No problem.
Well, sure.
That sounds like there's going to be problems.
What I'd like to ask you to sign some paperwork. just getting rid of any legal obligation on our part if this doesn't work out.
Well, as I understood it, and he kind of pulls out a copy of the contract you guys, Tavlin gave you. He's like looking it over. He said like, well, as I understand it, you are independent contractors. So. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. 1099.
Sure.
1099s, yeah.
1099s.
So you shouldn't have to worry about any legal ramifications.
Okay. Would you say that to somebody that you hired to help clean up a dead body, though? I mean, you'd still be committing a crime.
As an assessor.
And I don't really know what the legal... Anyway, you know what? I could use 10 gold pieces. I've always wanted to see how many bears could fit in one place.
She's paying off her law school
debt.
Yeah,
I'm paying off law school.
Okay, interesting.
Didn't work.
Oh, all that debt, and you didn't actually become a lawyer?
Yeah, I'm not that smart. I got into religion instead.
Well, I'm going to come with you in an attempt. I may be able to calm the bear while you try to administer the potion.
Okay. Great. Okay, great.
Do you have any other bear devices we should bring with us?
I'm an Ursamancer, not some sort of bear trapper.
Okay.
Whoa.
Jesus.
Well. Jeez.
Oh my gosh.
Okay. So I'll trust you then.
So I guess we should go. Should we hit the road?
Yeah. Let's hit the road.
Yes. Let's head out to the Lingering Woods. That seems like a very good point for our first break. If you're just joining us, as a quick recap, what you've missed so far, these guys got a job within...
It's like starting with the sixth Harry Potter book.
Got a job at the Mancers Guild, helping an Ursamancer named Kelto Bergman, who apparently decided it was a good idea to try and summon about 100 bears into the same point just to see what would happen, and inadvertently created a monstrosity known as the Ursipede, which is a bear with the head, front, and back legs of the bear, and around 100 bear legs in its center, about 100 feet long. And they need to help him try to dispel this creature into its component bear parts, or just kill it. And so they are on their way out to the Lingering Woods to do this. And we'll see what happens next as soon as we come back from this break. We will be right back.
Bye.
Bye.
Miss you.
Bye. Miss you.
Love you.
Thank you.
Hey guys, welcome back to Aristocrats. I'm Clay Larson, and we've got with us today Mary Holland, Shalia Evans, and Zach Bornstein. Hi guys, welcome back. If you guys are watching on Twitch and you want to vote on things as we go through this today playing, like the people who were here at the beginning of the show got to vote on what type of bear the ursipede was that they're going to be fighting, and voted on a polar bear.
Oh, great choice.
Aren't you glad I asked?
Yeah. One of the largest types of bears maybe made this fight harder for you than they would have otherwise.
That's all right. I mean,
you guys are dastardly.
What bear would be a non-issue, though?
Like a koala bear.
Oh.
Well. I mean, a black bear is considerably smaller than a polar bear.
Smaller, yes, but
still an issue.
A bear.
For sure.
Well, depends how old they are.
Bear's a bear.
Bear's a bear.
Bear's a bear, of course, of course.
Says the centaur.
Be here all day.
If you guys are watching on Twitch and you want to vote on things like that throughout the show today, you can go to jash.com/play. You keep watching the Twitch stream there. Also, if you are just joining us, maybe you haven't seen the show before or you've joined recently, you can watch old episodes. There's like a bug in the studio in front of me. Ugh. I look very professional.
There's a minor illusion.
If you want to watch older shows, you can go to our archive on YouTube at youtube.com/jashplay. I think we're up through episode 19 or 20. So we've got a few weeks. We're going to hopefully get up there soon. We'll do that. And then last thing I'm going to mention. Two more things. God, so much business, guys. We got another Patreon subscriber, so I wanted to say thank you, Pregnant Chipmunk. It's up on the screen there. Thank you, Pregnant Chipmunk, for subscribing to our Patreon. We are slowly building that up. We're going to release something every month. If you aren't sure if you want to subscribe, that's totally fine. We're giving away like a one PDF sheet a month with some fun stuff from the show. Last month, and it's going to be there up for everybody, is the Immedusa monster. Which you can download and use in a campaign at home if you want. And I'll actually say that the one for subscribers starting this month is going to be the ursipede. I've got the stat block for this creature that I made up, and you'll be able to download that. We haven't put it up yet, but it'll be there by the end of the month.
Is it going to look like my drawing?
You want to show up your drawing to the...
It's going to be this little guy.
Oh!
Here you go. The ursipede.
Now you don't need to use your imagination.
Now it's there for you. The tail's the best part.
That is an adorable tail.
The face is a disaster. Mm-hmm. It's like wearing shoes.
Mouse-like.
Yeah, I don't know how to
do like it. A shrew.
I don't even know what like a bear Elvis. Looks like in profile.
It is fantastic.
Wonderful.
I did my best.
Very, very close to what I was imagining.
Great. Good.
Yeah.
Oh, good.
Maybe thicker legs, but you know what? I'm not going to
change it. I phoned it in.
So we're going to get back into it in case you're joining us and want to recap. These guys got a job from an ursamancer to help him take down one of his experiments because he was trying to summon a bunch of bears into one spot. And accidentally created an ursipede, and they need to help him stop it. So we're going to get back into that in one sec. Last thing I've got to say, my producer is reminding me because I forgot to say it. Next week, we're going to have a special show. I won't be DMing next week. We're going to have Mark McCora, who has been on before, come on, and he's going to DM a Star Wars RPG. That I will play in instead of DMing. Ooh. So we're gonna do a one-off Star Wars game instead of a D&D game.
That's so fun.
I've never played this Star Wars RPG system. It's one from the 80s. What was it, Westinghouse?
West End Games.
West End Games' Star Wars system from the 80s. So we're gonna try that next week. So come check that out, especially if you like Star Wars.
You can wear an outfit? You gonna have a?
I haven't thought about it, but I guess maybe I should,
probably wear an
try
outfit.
To get like some...
Oh, yeah.
Brown robes?
Yeah. Just stick with neutrals. You'll be fine.
Stick with earth tones.
If I'm in Star Wars, I wear brown robes, right?
Yeah.
No, I feel like I wouldn't be like a Jedi if I was going to start. I think I'd have to
like a civilian.
Or like a bounty hunter, maybe.
Oh, well.
You could be Rey.
Could be Rey. I feel like that's similar to brown robes.
Thank you.
Very...
I don't remember most of the names from this.
I'm troubled if I can make a bounty hunter comment right now. Uh-huh. I recently saw in person Boba Fett's original costume, and it has a lot of braids of hair hanging off of it as if he's like murdered children and kept their hair.
I mean, he's a bounty hunter.
I know, but how has that never come to my attention before?
Yeah, I don't remember that.
I don't remember that either, but it was in the exhibit.
I mean, to be fair, he is not in much of the movies.
No, but hair trophies? It's dark. It's anyway, psycho. Just saying. Keep it in mind for next week.
Well, if you like Star Wars, you're going to get more of this, this scintillating, like, I never noticed that. Because I will have lots of them.
Great.
All right, let's get back into it, guys. So you guys are leaving the Mancer's Guild with Kelto Bergman, and Kelto is leading you along the road to the Lingering Woods. Mm-hmm. Now, you guys are not quite out of the city, but I wanted to give you the opportunity. Are you guys down to just, like, head out there, or... are you gonna ask any more questions, or like, do you have other stuff you wanted to do before you leave?
How long of a journey is it to the woods?
Well, it'll probably take us about an hour to get to the edge of the Lingering Woods, and then we'll have to find the Ursipede.
Oh, okay. Mm.
Okay, and is there anything we need to do in particular to lure it to us? Do we want to lure it to us, or do we want to, like, observe it first?
Well, I was hoping, as adventurers, one of you could help me track it.
Ooh.
Okay.
Are you hungry?
Let's see.
That seems like a bit of a left turn.
Well, it's a long walk.
Oh, I'm not. I ate a good breakfast.
Oh, okay.
Okay.
We'll okay.
I had a sugar packet, so. Mm-hmm.
That's some coffee.
Shall all right. We? Mm-hmm. Should we go? I think we've all got rations on us,
yeah,
right?
Yeah. We're good.
Just we're okay.
Forward. Yeah.
Did you guys not eat that you're worried about not eating after 1 hour?
Well, 1 hour there, however long it takes once we're there, 1 hour back. Then even when your day's over, we still have to go back to work.
Yeah, we still have to go
back. It's a long day without
to
eating. Yeah. And if we're, you know, fighting an ursipede,
you need energy.
We need energy.
Well... you said you have rations.
Yeah, 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 yeah. We'll be okay.
No, we'll
be
okay. Food.
We have food. We're just wondering if we're bringing enough.
Just wanted to, like, know before we.
Or if we need
get
better food. Because, you know, rations and lunch aren't the same.
Like,
thing.
You need protein.
Are all adventurers this concerned with their caloric intake? Mm.
They should be if they want to survive.
Absolutely.
They want to look good.
Yeah.
I just thought it would be more of a tally ho, let's go.
Oh, well,
sure.
Tally ho, let's go.
Yeah.
You know?
Fascinating. I've honestly been more of a bookworm myself than an adventurer, so I don't have a lot of experience.
You're covered in dirt.
Well, I go out into the woods a lot. I don't consider that. It's kind of, if you're working with bears, you're going to be in the woods a lot. I mean, you know.
So you're a bookworm in the woods.
I mean, when I'm in the office, it's sort of like you would consider the woods my lab.
Mm. An earthworm. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
I see what you did there. It's very good.
That's another Jennifer Love Hewitt bit.
Jennifer Love Hewitt. Swoosh.
She almost slips and hurts herself after that bit.
Oh, no.
Well, it's around 10:30 now. Shall we?
We should get in there. Let's get going.
Let's go.
I need that gold.
So what do we see? We just see the entrance to the woods. Is there a trail?
Well, so you guys leave the city.
Right.
Mm-hmm. And you get out of the gates, the city gates of Calmstone. And Calmstone's like a big enough city and has a big enough area that it's not like gates, immediate plains. It's more like you leave the city gates and a bit of a suburbs have sprung up around it. So there's like... houses, other buildings, stuff
kids
like that.
Kids on bikes.
Yeah, a lot of kids on bikes. But the further out you get, the more it starts dying off, the city. Not dying off, that sounds more sinister.
Oh, my God.
Converting more to, like, plains, farms, stuff like that. Mm-hmm. Eventually, it gets, like, not a
Trump
much
supporters.
More rural. And you get, eventually, you're just on kind of a dirt road. and you're approaching these woods. This is the tree line of the Lingering Woods.
Are they scary-looking woods, or like a fun, like, hey, we're going camping woods?
They're not scary.
Okay.
They're woods. They're not like, I don't know that I would describe them as fun.
Okay.
But dark, not like birds tweeting and...
I mean, on the edge there's birds tweeting, but like, I would say this, they don't look sinister.
All right. Okay. Is this like an East Coast woods or like a redwood forest kind of woods?
More East Coast.
Okay, so there's bramble to deal with.
Yeah, but there are paths that go through.
Okay.
Like,
what time of year is it? Are there tourists there for the foliage?
It is not fall.
It's not.
It
fall.
Is early summer,
it's
not
a
lot.
It's still pretty.
It looks good.
Mm-hmm.
It's not dead or anything. But yeah, the path you are on as it enters the woods starts twisting more. Okay. So you can't really see like a direct line into the woods.
I see. Mm-hmm.
But you could stick on the path that you're on for now if you want.
Are there any interesting mushrooms or things that we should be gathering?
Are you asking about, do you want to forage for mushrooms?
Well, I have a side business where I sell truffles, so I would, if we have time,
sure,
I would love to forage for some truffles.
Do you want
to
start looking?
No, we should probably focus.
Can I create
I
a minor illusion of a beautiful, like, expensive truffle right in front of her?
Sure.
Okay.
Okay, and I see the truffle.
So this is going to be an opposed intelligence check. So it's against we'll do against your spell save. On the lower box.
Oh, 14?
14. So roll an intelligence check.
Covered in food.
And I do my 20, right?
Roll your 20 and then add your intelligence bonus, okay, which is plus 3.
18.
21.
So 21.
So you are able to tell them that is an illusion.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, nice try. Nice try. Well, this is so fun. Aren't we having fun?
Kelto is kind of like staring at you guys and kind of says like, no, it's a lot of fun. I feel like we should be a little more urgently looking for this
abomination
bear.
We just love to joke around.
We're goofsters.
We're goofsters.
We're just such goofsters.
You are so much more goofy than I imagined adventurers to be.
Well, you have to have a sense of humor when you're putting your life on the line.
That's true.
I guess that's a good point, sure.
Yeah. Great, so we should start tracking this bear, huh?
Mm-hmm.
Yes, now, who is your most experienced tracker?
Ooh, good question.
I'll tell you this. If anybody is trained in nature or survival, you might be better at it.
Let me see where we're trained.
Your training is there.
Oh, my training is here.
It's underneath the first wide box.
I have almost all performance-based skills.
Oh, right. Okay.
I have a little bit of nature and some insight.
That makes sense. You're
perception.
You're a woodwife.
Perception. Mm-hmm.
Yeah,
that's
good. I know I'm good with animals.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so maybe we're gonna let's try my first plan. Why don't we all listen and see if we hear a bear?
That's your plan? We're doing that already, Shalia.
But we might as well like make an actual effort to listen and see if we hear
Are
a bear.
Are you just politely telling us to shut up right now?
So well, we've been loud.
Your suggestion is that you all like actively like be quiet and listen for the bear.
I'm just actually just gonna go shh.
So roll a perception.
Oh, God, for that? Okay.
Are you guys all actually shushing when she says it? Kelto does.
Yes, I will shush.
I will shush.
I had a 5, and then what do I add to
perception
that?
Perception is wisdom.
Plus 3, so 8.
You hear birds?
Yep.
You hear what we're hearing right now.
Oh, nope, no bears. Sorry, guys, I thought I heard something.
Okay.
That's okay.
Well, we could track it. Do any of you have any experience tracking wood wildlife?
Do we have any scat?
Oh, there
boy.
Any,
oh, God.
Here we
scat.
Go.
I brought a little
joke.
Bit of scat.
Do we have any scat around?
Any scat?
Scat.
Well, you could look for some.
Oh great.
You roll. So
yeah,
you
let's look for
nature.
Scat.
So if you want to see if you can find any clues to the bear.
Yeah, bear clues.
So long.
You want to roll.
The longest scat. It's like 100 feet long.
Oh, 100 feet of bear intestines. It probably loops around like a human's intestines, so that's like...
Like a football field of scat.
It would be hard to miss it.
Hard to miss.
Oh, we're stepping in.
So if you want to do a nature check to see if you can find any clues to
great.
Roll your d20 and add your nature bonus.
Okay. 5 again. And then my nature bonus is just plus 1, so 6.
Okay. So you don't really find anything at this point. Now, you're pretty close to the entrance to the woods, so...
Right, okay. So we have to go in deeper.
Yeah, so it doesn't... It's not shocking that you wouldn't find anything here, even with a 6.
I have candles. Could we just burn down the woods, and that way we deal with the bear?
my God. Are you
putting that forest?
It would be dazzling.
Putting that forest to Keltham.
We're in the forest.
We're an hour out from help.
All right, I'll stop. I won't do that. I'm sorry.
Keltham just, like, since you guys were commenting, I assume you did put that idea forth, and he's kind of like, we are not burning down the forest.
Okay.
Okay, I think we should keep walking.
Yeah, we can just walk.
Okay.
Keep walking.
So as you guys walk further in, you're on the path, and the path eventually kind of like, it was like a road coming out of Calmstone, and then it turned into more of a dirt road, more of a dirt path, and the further into the forest, the more it starts seeming more like, we're talking like deer path. Like, it clearly like is going from like a path people regularly travel to something that like is a little more defined than the actual, like, a road. But it's still, like, you're getting into something that's, like, not a lot of, like, humans have, like, carved out a path or anything.
And are there any mushrooms around there?
I keep telling you, you can do an investigation check for mushrooms.
Yeah, I'll do an investigation check for mushrooms. It's a really lucrative business.
Go ahead.
Here we go.
They're very expensive.
Yeah.
13. 13. You do find a few mushrooms. They're not like the most beautiful things you've ever seen.
Right.
But they're like something that are edible.
Okay. I'll grab them.
Okay. There's like, we'll say there's like, what do you call the top of a mushroom?
Cap.
Yeah. You find like 4 caps worth of mushrooms. Large caps.
Druggy?
You said that as if you were being sly.
Are they drugs?
No.
Oh, okay.
Do we eat them now? Are you eating them? Can we eat now?
Yeah, you guys. Yeah, here. Dig in.
Well, do we know what kind of mushrooms they are?
They're edible.
They're edible.
Oh, but are they poisonous? Shit, how do I check if they're poisonous?
I mean, I'll say if you have a business doing this.
I know.
You're with a 13. You would know that these ones, they're not poisonous.
Okay, great.
It's up to you if you want to share.
I would love to share. Please.
I'd give you a gold or two to offset the cost, because obviously you were going to sell these at market.
No, it's okay. It's okay.
Do you want some of my whey?
These aren't truffles. They're just straight up mushrooms. What's up?
I'm sorry.
I wonder if you want some of my whey.
No, I don't want any of your whey powder. Am I going to put it on my tongue?
What's up, Calto?
It just seems like we're spending a lot of time on these mushrooms.
Calto, we're trying to make a day of it.
Calto, did you hire us? Or?
We work at a temp agency. We need side businesses.
Yeah.
I'm just worried that I don't know what this ursipede could be doing while we're honestly dilly-dallying.
It could be eating on those mushrooms.
It could be.
Don't you have some kind of bear tracking magic?
Yeah, what do you, you know
your
about
whole
bears.
Thing is bear magic.
Yeah.
You know where you made it.
Yeah.
I mean, sure, I can I was closer to the edge of the forest when I made it, and it went deeper in.
Right.
Okay.
We should go deeper.
Look, I mean, I can try to track it, but I'm no tracker.
Can I look for footprints?
Yeah, sure.
Okay.
Do you want to roll
so
a...
It'll be a lot of them, right? Be a lot of footprints.
Let me check one thing. So are you going to roll... How do you want to look for the footprints is what I'm asking.
Oh.
Like, are you looking just like... investigating for them, or are you trying to like look for it in a kind of like survival way of like, well, the idea of where a bear would walk and stuff like that? What's your character's mindset as he's looking for
it? I'm trying to put myself in the mind of, because like I'm very method as a bard, so I'm trying to put myself in the mind of the ursipede.
Okay.
So I'm thinking about where would I walk if I was an ursipede. I know, you know, it can't go through thicker parts of brambles. It has to go, because it's a big animal, it has to make certain paths. Decisions.
So we'll say that's a nature check.
Okay.
So roll that, and nature is intelligence.
Okay.
So you're going to roll a d20 and add that bonus.
Two?
Wait.
I got a one. But...
You got a one. That's a natural one.
Okay. Ooh, boy.
You fail.
Yikes.
So I'll tell you this. You are pretty sure that, I feel like a bear would want to get out of the woods as soon as possible. Probably is more of an urban animal.
Uh-oh.
That's what you think.
Oh, because I'm stupid. It's the opposite.
Yeah.
But I don't realize that. Your
character believes this.
Like, I get what you're saying, but my character doesn't.
Yeah.
Okay.
Also, someone in the chat room asked how long an ursipede is. This one's probably like, I said 100, it's over 100 feet. Jesus. I'm trying to figure out, it's probably around 120 feet-ish.
Oh my God. Because
the legs are also, like, more packed together than a bear's legs normally are.
Okay.
Bear's legs aren't packed together normally.
Not at all.
Exactly.
So, still no signs of this bear.
As of now, he
great.
Had no clue about the bear.
I mean, I think we should go back in the city.
No, we're not going back in the city.
He can get more bananas.
If it goes
investigation, we should go back to the city.
If we go back, if the bear winds up, if the ursipede winds up in the city, somebody will shoot it and they'll be done with. We're trying to prevent it from getting there.
I guess. Okay. Well, I'll follow you guys.
I have an idea for bringing out the ursipede. I would like to use my druid craft to make the sound of a wounded fur seal.
Fur seal?
Yes, because this is primarily a polar bear.
Okay.
So I'd like to make the sound of a wounded fur seal.
Very okay. smart.
That's great.
And you know what? And this is my druid craft. I can use it all the time. So while we're walking, I just want to keep doing that.
All right. Just throwing it over.
I'm going to tell you this, because I was not expecting that. I'll tell you this. You don't hear anything immediately, but especially because you keep doing it. I'll just tell you that is going to help you find the ursipede.
Okay. Okay.
Maybe not, no.
That's great. Also, oh my goodness. This is why they were asking about the length of the bear, because the chat room must have just looked up that the intestines would be 96,000 feet.
So the poop would be 96,000 feet.
So we're really looking for the poop.
We're looking for 96.
How many miles is it?
Can I smell anything?
Miles are like 5,000 feet-ish?
It would be...
That's a ton.
It would be a lot.
That's a ton. Can I smell
miles? 18 miles. 18 miles of poop.
And how big are these woods?
18 miles? Yeah, I mean, they're longer than 18 miles, but they're big. Also, to be
imagine
fair,
if it had diarrhea. It would be like a tidal.
Intestines don't work that way. You don't
poop
the length of your intestines every time you poop.
If you're healthy, you do.
But if let's say it eats like a berry, it would take like days, weeks maybe, for it to go through its digestive system.
Oh, so this thing.
When did you create this thing?
Yeah.
This happened last weekend.
Last week? Why did you just call us now?
I was trying to deal with it on my own. Didn't work.
What have you done so far that didn't work?
Looked for it.
Have you had any other temp adventurers try to go for it and they got hurt or killed?
No, I have not.
Okay.
So we're the first?
That's good.
Has anybody died yet?
No.
What is it rampaging then if it's in the woods?
What is it rampaging?
Yeah.
I mean, every time I've seen it, it looks very upset, and any time I've tried to approach it, it has chased. It's chased.
How did you find it?
Yeah, how did
you
find it last
tracker?
Time?
The first time I found it, I went back to the exact spot where I was, and it was closer to that. Every time I've seen it, it's been further away from that spot, seemingly getting deeper into the woods.
Mm. Can I look for bear tracks now?
Sure.
Okay, here I go.
Shoot.
Okay, and then what's the one with wisdom?
We'll just say nature.
It's
wisdom.
Wisdom.
So
there's nothing.
You also.
Damn.
So you guys are not having a lot of luck.
Well, hang on.
Well, what's going on with the fur seal sounds?
You're still making it.
Oh, okay.
Are you guys, now let me ask you this. Are you still walking further into the woods as you go?
Yes.
Yeah. Yes.
So as you're going, you haven't found much, but the first seal sounds, you hear some rustling.
That was great.
Ooh.
Okay.
Shh. Yeah. Do you want to...
Can we listen?
You want to listen?
Can we listen?
Do a perception. All of you do... Actually, we'll just do your passive perceptions. It's enough. So you guys all hear this rustling, and it doesn't... I'll say this. Even though you haven't seen it, it doesn't really sound large enough to be an ursipede.
Okay. It could be a friend.
It could be, yeah. Do you want to approach the rustling?
Yes.
Yeah. What if they've seen it?
What if it's food?
So you guys approach the rustling, and as you get closer, all of a sudden, a deer jumps out.
Oh. Hello.
And I cast a friend spell on it.
A friend spell is only going to work on another human.
Oh.
Well, but I can make animal friendship, but then I can't use it on the Ursa. I should save that for the Ursapine. And the I got to save those. I can't talk to this deer.
Well, you have two spells.
I know, but it might take a lot with this frickin' bear monster you made.
Am I able to whisper to it?
To the deer?
Yeah.
Do you speak deer?
No. Or do I?
No, you don't.
Okay. Why did you ask me?
Okay. How about this? How about can I offer the deer some of my non-poisonous mushrooms and make friends with it?
Sure, you can try that.
Okay, yeah. Here you go, deer.
It's going to be an animal handling check. Mm-hmm. So it's wisdom, but because you are a centaur and have four legs like it, I'll give you advantage on this.
Thank you.
So you're going to roll a animal handling check. So roll your d20. It's wisdom, so you don't have a bonus, but you're going to roll twice and use the higher number.
Okay.
Four.
Come on, motherfucker.
Oh.
That is a natural 20, which is definitely higher than a 4.
Yeah,
great. So
it was the 4.
The deer immediately comes up to you and starts eating the mushrooms.
Okay.
And is, like, not afraid of you at all.
Okay. And now, because I rolled a 20, can I communicate with my eyes? Does that make sense?
You can stare into the deer's eyes for sure. And it is not scared of you.
Is the deer now my best friend?
The deer is now your good friend, not best friend.
Oh, it has another best friend.
You guys just met.
Okay. Who's his best friend? I'm just kidding.
Can we pet it?
You can.
Oh, okay. We should hang back a little.
You guys haven't, like, really approached it yet.
Can I create a little simple illusion?
Sure.
Salt lick.
Oh, but then I'll be mad. Oh, it'll be mad that there's no salt lick.
Oh, God.
Yeah, it's okay. I'll intro you guys to. Is it a he or a she or a...
You're not trained in nature, so you would have to kind of look more closely.
Can we do a genital check?
Yes. I kneel down.
Roll
I
a genital get on check.
My lift its tail.
It is a male.
Great.
Male deer. Young male deer. You guys, should I? Here's the thing. This will mean I won't get to talk unless.
Right.
Here's the thing. I can do animal friendship, and I can speak with animals, but I could do one of them twice, or I could do. Split them up, but either way, we're losing a chance to deal with.
Also,
I think you're right.
Just to be totally clear, I believe two of you have speak with animals.
Oh. I have it as well.
Oh,
and I've already made friends with it.
Okay,
so
okay.
Already friends with
Wait, so you have speak with animals still? So then I'll do this one, and you hang on to that one for later, for the bear.
Oh, okay.
Right. So then we're at least still talking to it.
Well, you can use that one again, can't she?
I could if I want to.
Oh.
Yeah. But you could too.
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh,
I'm gonna.
Oh, I see what
I'm gonna
you mean.
Speak with.
Mean.
I'm gonna speak with
don't
the deer.
Waste it.
Okay.
Okay.
Meow.
So I meow 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 meow.
You don't have. So
I don't
you're
have
gonna
to roll.
You're casting it.
Yeah.
So you're gonna cast speak with animals, and it's you don't have to roll. It gives you now have the ability to comprehend and verbally communicate with animals for the duration, which is about 10 minutes.
Great.
Now. So the way this works is it's sort of limited by their intelligence. Like, you know, you're not going to find out this beer can do physics problems.
Mm-hmm.
But, like, information, like, they would have, you can ask about and get.
Great.
Sure. So you cast that spell.
Right. Hello, deer.
Hello.
Hi.
And can I hear it? It's my best friend.
No.
I can't hear it?
But you see it look. And he's making, to you guys, it sounds like, small, deer sounds. I guess I don't know what a deer sounds like.
Don't they make it like...
I think it would be like that.
I feel like they like honk a little.
It would be like a little like goat honky, but like softer, I think.
Yeah, a soft goat honk.
Oh my God, he's
someone
honking.
Someone in the chat room is going to tell us that we are so wrong with what a deer sounds like when it makes me.
We're just going to just send a video of me going, it says deer sounds.
He's honking, he's honking.
He's honking. Hi.
Hi.
We mean you no harm.
Okay.
May I ask, have you seen any horrifying monsters in the woods today? Yeah, did you see a bear?
A bear that's not a bear?
With hundreds of legs?
Yeah,
Was it like 18 miles long?
The intestines are.
I don't know what a mile is.
Was it just a
very long
bear? A very long bear? You did. You saw him.
Yes.
Where did you see him?
And it kind of like looks over its shoulder, like not directly behind it, but that way from where it's standing.
That way?
Yes.
It's just down there.
It's so angry.
Oh no, what, did it do anything to you personally?
No, I ran.
Thank you. Oh good, thank goodness. Don't mess with that bear, okay? Need to be safe.
No, yeah, we all are staying out of its way.
How long ago? How long ago was that?
How long ago was what?
The seeing the bear.
Earlier today,
was it like when the sun was in a different spot or pretty recently? Morning, great. It was in the morning. Have you seen anything unusual since?
Unusual?
Yeah, something out of the ordinary for the forest.
It looks at all three of you.
Besides us.
I mean, the bear that's not a bear, yes. Mm-hmm. That, I saw that. Unusual.
Yes. Okay. How are you?
I'm good.
Good. How did you sleep?
I'm sorry.
How did you sleep?
Fitfully.
Good. That sounds great. Thank you for your help. Do you know if there's any other animals around here?
The birds.
Oh, that's true. Thank you. Mm-hmm. Anybody, any other deer nearby or just you?
No.
All right. Well, be careful out there, buddy.
My brothers and sisters say I'm the bravest of us, so that's why I'm here.
Oh.
And I took a deer that's not a deer's mushrooms.
Oh, yeah, this is a centaur. Have you met a centaur before? No, it's part lady. Part horse.
What are you saying to it?
Hold on, guys, hold on. All right.
It's looking
you've
at
been
you.
Great. Cool. You've been so helpful. I don't want to keep you any longer than I need to. So off that way is where you saw the bear this morning.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Thank you for your help. You do what you gotta do in life.
Okay.
Follow your dream.
Do you have more mushrooms?
Oh, would you like some more mushrooms?
Yes, please.
Yeah, okay. Can I talk to people again for a second? Use people voice?
Sure.
Guys, the deer says that he saw the bear this morning off that way, but he'd love some more mushrooms.
Oh, sure, yeah.
Can you have some more mushrooms?
Yeah, of course.
I'm shocked that those came in handy, but that's wonderful.
Well, here's my little deer friend.
There
I gave
you
him
go.
The mushrooms. Mm-hmm.
Starts eating them.
Oh, God, he's so cute.
Thank you. And now, I'm not going to, little deer, I'm not going to be able to talk to you forever. So, if you're out and about in the woods and you see any more bear that isn't a bear-related danger, will you come find us and, like, do a fun wiggle? Just like one of these, a little shoulder wiggle, and we'll know.
The deer tries to copy you and, like, it doesn't do it well because, like, deer's bodies don't work like ours. But it, like, kind of, like, bends down on one side and on the other.
Good. He's okay. That's perfect.
Are you hurting me?
So if you see the bear, then you'll come back and you'll do that and then look in the direction you saw it. Sound good? And we'll get you more mushrooms.
More mushrooms?
If you can help, yeah.
Okay.
Bye, deer. We don't need you anymore.
That's so rude.
Do you have more mushrooms now, though?
Oh, yeah. Do we have more mushrooms still?
Those are pretty much all the mushrooms.
Those are all the mushrooms? Okay. Oh,
that's
we're
good.
Out. We're out for now. Do
ask
you want
if it wants
whey.
It
do you
immediately
want any whey? Oh, bye. Jesus. Goodbye.
Bye.
Wait, quick, before, is it still, has it been 10 minutes? It hasn't been 10 minutes. Guys, birds. Birds!
Roll a charisma check. He's just yelling, birds, attracts the birds.
Oh, boy. Oh, one.
All
nope.
The birds fly away.
Oh, damn it.
All right, well, guys, okay, so we know where the bear was this morning, and the deer's gonna give us a little wiggle later.
Great.
If he sees anything.
It's probably in the city, right?
It's probably not in the city.
I think it's in the city.
There's no way it's in the city.
Yeah,
I just
the
have
direction
a good inkling of it.
Is sort of like, it's not the direction you were going in, but it's, if you were going, you guys were probably heading like northwest, and it was like directly north from
there. Oh, due north, guys.
Okay, so let's head due north.
Let's head north.
Clip clop, clip clop, clip clop.
So you guys are definitely going off the path that you were on.
Okay. That's all right.
Do you have to like step over things?
Yeah, it's like now you're in the woods. It's not a path.
Should we leave breadcrumbs or anything?
If you want to.
You have rope. But we might not.
We might need 50 feet.
We might need that.
Maybe I'll. You know what I don't need is the tinder box because I can create a bonfire. I'll like break up my little match. I don't know how I'll find that in the woods. Maybe that's pointless.
I have whey. We can just sprinkle whey and just make a little hole, and then it will.
Your protein powder is sponsored by Muscle Milk.
the character with what is it? Like, what do you have for strength? Like an 8?
A 6.
A 6. Sponsored by Muscle Milk.
I'm very charming. I changelinged into a stronger man.
Yeah, I guess a changeling could look as strong as he wants.
Look strong when I can change.
Gosh, do we need to worry about losing our way or not really?
No, I've got plenty of way.
Kelto kind of pipes in and says, like, well, I know these woods quite well, and I'm sure I can get us back to the city if you're worried.
Amazing, what if he dies, Kelto. Though? What if he dies?
Kelto, we're not going to let you die.
Yeah. Jesus. Oh, man.
Be cool. Concerned.
No.
It's very concerning.
No.
If you die, we're stuck.
If you die,
and I'm dead.
If you die, we don't get paid.
Before you die.
So we will not.
Yeah, we won't let you die.
We won't let you die.
Why was that not the first thing you said? That's stressful to me.
I wasn't going
to
intentionally cause your death or anything.
We need the cash.
Oh, I thought you were going to get cash. I'm going to bribe you. Shut up about it.
So you guys are walking north still?
Yes.
While you're talking about all this?
Yes.
So Kelto has assured you that he can get you back.
Great.
Mm. He's a little worried by the fact that you guys seem genuinely worried about him dying.
Yeah. There's a monster bear that is specifically probably mad at you, man. You've put yourself in a rough position.
Point conceded.
Yeah.
Point conceded. Mm-hmm. Look, do one of you want to take the potion of dispelling? Because, again, I would love to not have to kill this beautiful creature.
I feel like whoever has the best relationship with animals.
Should I be carrying it?
I think you probably should.
Okay, I can carry it.
Okay. So he hands you the potion of dispelling. It's
Thank you.
Glass vial. It's about this big.
Great.
It's a decent amount of liquid.
Okay. I have a backpack with me, so I'll put it in my backpack.
Okay.
Great.
So you guys are still walking along. Are you still making the fur seal sounds?
I'm trying to as often as I can because they don't travel that far.
Okay.
They only travel. Like 30 feet or so.
Yep.
So we have to get pretty close.
Yeah. But if you wouldn't if it was laying down or something for all
What if it's asleep?
It certainly would hear that.
But it would have to hear it from the front end. It doesn't matter if the sound reaches its butt.
Can't hear out its butt, no. Mm-hmm.
Okay. Although who knows what mysteries an Ursipede's butt holds? Who knows?
Butt holds.
Butthole.
You are charming.
Thank you.
So you guys are walking along, and you're heading north.
Mm-hmm.
And do you want to do anything else? Like you've been going for like a half hour now. You're pretty far north.
Oh.
Do you want to check for any more like signs or anything?
Let's check for footprints.
Okay.
I'll do that.
Mm-hmm.
8 plus
wisdom
0.
You don't see it.
Shoot. Oh,
can I check for footprints?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
You can do something else too if you want.
Oh. Footprints. 10 plus 0.
So you don't see any footprints, but I'll say with a nature check, you do note that there are like a lot more broken branches in this area than you had noticed before.
Can I pick one up and smell it?
Sure.
For bear?
Sure.
Okay.
Smell it for bear.
animal handling check.
Okay.
Which is still wisdom.
Wisdom. 20?
Yeah.
13 plus 0.
Okay. So you're not, you don't really smell anything that you would specifically say bear.
Mm.
It sort of just smells like the woods to you. Mm. But Kelto does see what you're doing and comes over and says, like, does it have the scent?
I can't tell.
Give it here. And he takes it, and Kelto takes a big whiff.
Why are we sniffing wood?
That was a creep of me.
Yes, I do. Yep, there is the musk of...
Ugh. You're sweating.
It's hot out here.
No, it's not. It's breezy.
This was broken by the Ursipede. It's somewhere reason. Mm.
How close?
I can't tell exactly how close from the smell, but...
Well, you're sniffing wood. I don't know what you can tell or can't.
It's recent enough that this musk is still on it a decent amount.
Okay.
Is it like a cologne? Is it nice?
You couldn't smell it. You already tried to smell.
I know. I was just wondering if you smelled something nice.
I mean, it smells like a male bear.
Okay. Mm.
So should we keep going?
Well, here's a question. If it was nearby, what's the forest looking like at this point? What kind of trees we got going on here?
A lot of some oaks, some elms.
Mm. Oaks, elms. Okay. What's the tallest one, and how dense are these trees? How far apart are they?
They're not so dense that you, like, have to, like, squeeze through them. Okay. Like, there's brambles and brushes and stuff, but, like, the larger, like, thick trunk trees are, like, far enough apart that you don't have to squeeze between them.
Mm-hmm.
Are you asking, like, in terms of, like, climbing one?
Yeah. How tall? What's the tallest?
You could definitely try to climb one, for sure. The canopy at the top, it's not like a rainforest canopy. Like, it's not dark where you are. Sun is getting through.
Okay.
You should change into a bird and get going.
Can I change into a bird?
I think you have to... I think changelings can only change into humanoid type.
What's a real rascally climber?
Yeah.
I could change into that dwarf we saw.
Is he going to be better at climbing?
Whoa. Just assume he's going to climb a tree.
You could also just try to climb it.
Could just try to climb a tree.
I can buck you up.
Okay. I am so little. Okay, I'll try to climb the tree.
Okay. So you're going to do... That's going to be a dexterity check?
Dexterity. Okay.
Ooh, your dexterity is pretty good.
20?
Yeah.
10.
10 with the bonus?
With the bonus.
Okay. I will say that's actually enough that you can start climbing up.
Oh,
okay.
You can't get all the way to the top, like, easily. Like, you're starting to climb. But you're not falling or anything.
Okay.
So you get about halfway up the tree, and there's more branches. Do you want to keep going?
I could help one of them up?
Yeah, you could do that.
Not me.
No, let's not even
try to
make a
horse.
I want to.
Half a horse climb a tree is not fair.
I'll keep going.
Okay.
Roll another dexterity check.
Okay. 9 plus 3, 12.
12? Okay, yeah, so you were able to get back up to the top.
Oh, great.
And you're about as high as you can recently get. You're not right at the tip top.
Sure.
So you're there. What are you doing?
I'm going to look.
For the bear itself?
Well, first I'm going to take in the view.
Mm-hmm.
Just, I've never been up this high in the woods. Is it pretty?
So ugly.
It's ugly.
No, I'm kidding. It's fine. It's fine.
Nothing to write home about.
It's cool. You have a decent view. This is a taller tree out of the ones around you. So you, from where you are, you can see towards the north and a little to the northeast.
Okay.
You can see. It seems like the trees kind of thin out a bit there.
Do I see the bear up there?
You don't see the bear itself because, like, from where you're at, like, the view of the ground in that direction starts to get obscured by the other trees.
Mm.
Like, you can't, there's not a clear line to the floor of the forest that far away, but.
But you could see, like branches and stuff moving around, right? Like, the tops of the trees.
Yeah, if something's if you're looking for motion near that, so at first you think it must be a clearing or something. But then you notice, like, so this is, like, on the other side of where you thought that clearing was. You do see, like, one tree that's, like, shaking a bunch.
Okay. Does anyone have binoculars?
No. No one has binoculars. I'll just tell you that right now.
Okay.
No.
Well, I'm gonna try to like gesture at them.
Uh huh. This is far enough away that you can talk.
Okay. Speak up. Just say what. Say what it is. Guys. Say what it is.
Oh, here we go.
Oh man.
He's doing his entertainer stuff.
So he's you're trying mind. To mime it out mind. To them.
He's yeah. Pretending like he's
roll
in a box.
Roll a performance check.
Okay. Which one's that?
That's gonna be your charisma, oh. And I think you're trained in performance.
17.
Oh.
That. What'd you roll?
13.
13. Isn't your performance
your, oh,
plus six?
Plus six.
19.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
19. So you guys get across that he's trying to mime out that the bear is in that direction.
Okay. Yeah. Great.
Great. Wow. So such good miming. Wow.
Yeah, really good.
Really good.
I believed you were climbing
that took
a rope.
Long enough that as you're up there and you look back in that direction, so the tree that tree had been shaking for a while. That tree, you didn't really hear much. Because it's just far enough away that the sound wouldn't carry it, but okay. You see that tree like topple.
Oh,
it's toppling.
The tree toppled.
Yeah. So I should get down.
Well, you better hurry.
I'd like to get down.
Okay. You climb back down.
Yeah.
Yeah, you're able to get down pretty
easily. Excellent.
Without hurting yourself.
Okay.
Good job.
Thank you.
Good job.
So are you filling them in?
I'll just kind of fill them in.
Kelto kind of like furrows his brow and says, it's possible it's reverting to certain behaviors, like maybe trying to scratch its now huge back on a tree when no tree could take that weight.
Oh. Yikes. That's gotta be hard on its spine, too.
Yeah, if it's going up like that.
Oh, it's like my dachshund.
Whoa, you have a dog.
I have a dog, you guys. Should I have brought my dog on this mission?
No, it would
have
been fun.
I don't
probably
think she'd
more mushrooms.
She'd get tired.
Yeah.
She'd
it's
be so
possible
tired.
That the bear is reverting to typical average bear behaviors, even though it is no longer the average bear.
But polar bears don't have trees that...
So...
Well, not all of the bears were polar bears that... I saw.
Oh, but it's primarily polar bears. Mm-hmm.
So we should make the fur seal sound again if it's reverting back to its normal bear behaviors, because
yeah,
it might respond
yeah.
to it.
Well, how far away was
it? Oh, yeah, how
this?
Far away was that?
How far away was it?
It seemed like it was,
yeah, that's
weird. Like quarter mile.
It was a quarter mile.
Quarter mile.
It was a quarter
okay,
mile.
Well, we need to get closer for that fur seal
it
noise.
It was about,
to
like,
me.
1/80th of the bear's intestine.
Quarter of a mile is what? Is what? Is
it's 1,200 feet-ish?
Oh,
there's
no, there is a bug in here.
13?
It's a minor illusion.
1,300? 1,300
feet.
I'm cackling.
Did you get it? Should we roll to see if Mary got it? Yeah.
Roll to see your attack on the bug.
18!
You hit the bug!
Oh, you hit that bug.
Now it's turn to hit you. So Kelto kind of says, like, I feel like we all know about what a quarter mile is. We should head over that
yeah,
way.
Yeah, we should head that way.
And it's now probably like 1:30.
Oh,
you
wow.
Guys, like, mm-hmm. You guys have been walking for a bit yeah. And then these little encounters.
What's the deadline?
5:30.
Oh, shit.
Okay, we should go.
We're running out of food.
We gotta go.
No, we're running out of time, not
oh,
food.
Oh, time.
Yeah, if you want to get back in time for a scone raid or anything like that, you're going to have to do that.
Scone raid.
We got raided by another channel, and we were told to say the word scone raid.
Oh.
Scone raid.
Are scone they raid is happening
raid?
Right now.
What does that mean?
A bunch of people from another Twitch channel come in, and all start saying the same thing to fill up the chat room, and they're saying scone raid.
Scone raid!
Scone raid!
Scone raid!
I'm so sad, because I thought that meant that outside this room there were people from another channel taking your scones, and I was ready to rumble.
Taking our scones? You just thought we had a huge table of scones?
Well, that was the other part of my excitement.
That we did not tell you about.
You haven't told me about anything, so...
It was a minor illusion.
Well... There is a scone raid going back in Calmstone.
Oh,
and if you guys want to get some scones before the end of the day,
yeah, we have to hurry.
Okay, we have to hurry. So we go No, you just saw it in the woods.
It must have been something else. I think the bear's in the city.
It's not in the city.
I'm going to give a quick recap for all those people who are coming in on what's going on.
Great.
In case they can't tell. Because we seems we just got a bunch more people in, just to recap what's going on right now. These guys got a temp adventurer contract to help out an Ursamancer, a wizard who focuses primarily on bears. An Ursamancer... And they found out that this Ursamancer had tried to summon too many bears into the exact same point in space and time. And basically the bears combined into an Ursipede.
An Ursipede! It's an Ursipede!
Hello! Hello, little Ursipede! Oh, you hate this!
Hi, little one.
Oh, stay here, baby. Stay here.
Hi. Okay.
Hi.
It's okay, honey.
That would be a canopy.
A canopy.
Is a bear that is, I don't know which camera I should go to. An Ursipede is a bear that looks like a normal bear, except if you stretched out its midsection, it has around 100 extra legs.
Oh my God!
God, there's just legs everywhere.
Its intestines are falling out by the mile.
Carnage.
Also, the chat users earlier calculated for us that a Ursipede, a bear that was 120 feet long, would have 96,000 foot long intestines. But yes, that dog is exactly what a bear, an Ursipede would look like as a dog. A caninipede? Caninipede.
Caninipede.
Caninipede. I'm just saying words now.
Weren't we all ready?
None of us knew that dog with cosplaying as an Ursipede was going to come in, and that was amazing. Now its paper legs are left there as a reminder.
Yeah. I'll wear them.
Oh,
it's okay.
God.
But anyways, what's been going on, to recap, is these guys have been tracking the Ursipede in the lingering woods with the help of Kalto, the Ursamancer. And they just found it. So
what?
You found it. You're the one who found it.
No, we saw the rustling.
You saw the wrestling, yeah.
Oh.
You assume that is...
I still think it's in the city.
The game is afoot.
Yes, we'll go toward the wrestling.
So the Kalto kind of says, like, excellent, let's go keep up that... If it is primarily polar bear, which it is...
I mean, any bear would want to get into that dead seal sound, dying seal sound.
Right. Yeah. It's specifically dying seal.
It, well, okay, injured fur seal.
What does it sound like?
I'm going to go with... again, probably another honk.
Is that the deer?
Another honk sound.
Sorry, can I hear that one more time? So a dying fur seal is very bored.
Well, it doesn't... What else is it going to do? It can't...
Yeah.
It needs to make a sound. They don't really make sounds.
Honestly, I've never heard a fur seal, so I don't know why I'm giving you shit.
Yeah, you don't know.
Yeah, it's true, I don't.
I'll find out. Maybe I'm right.
I hope you go and look that up.
Yeah,
so you guys approach the direction that Steve pointed you in. And with that sound still going, like, you're getting close, and all of a sudden, you slowly start hearing, like, a lot, like... As you're getting closer, you're still a little ways away. Like, you get, like, half of the distance. And you hear another, like, loud...
Another tree fell. Mm.
And then as you keep getting closer, you hear a lot of rustling. And that rustling seems to be getting closer to you.
Okay, and how close? Like, wait, like, what's the foot? What's the feet?
What's the feet?
What's the feet?
If your guess. Do a perception check.
Okay, what's the feet?
Oh!
No!
I mean,
perfect 20. It really is.
It
really
is, though.
Damn it.
That should count. That's too cool. That should count.
11.
With your wisdom, so 11. You think it's probably around, like, 100 feet away still, maybe a bit longer, but
okay.
You can tell it seems closer.
I'm gonna do something.
Okay.
Okay, I'm going to use my dash action, which will allow me to gallop 120 feet.
Yeah.
And then I'm going to use my sleepy.
So I'll tell you this.
What do you guys think?
That's great.
I will tell you this real fast. You can gallop, because there are woods, so you can't, it would be hard for you to find a straight line. You're not going to be able to go quite as far.
Oh, okay. Because,
like, that's assuming, like, you've got a straight path to gallop that far. That said, if you want to gallop forward, you could totally do that. I'd say you could probably gallop, like, 80 feet ahead.
Okay.
That might still be enough, close enough to see it.
Okay, creatures within 20 feet of a point you choose within range are affected. Boy. What do you guys think?
Why don't we just walk towards it?
Should we just move closer? I was going to do a surprise attack. Oh, yeah. Maybe you're right.
No, listen, if you want to do it, I'm not saying you can't.
No,
I'm saying,
you clearly think it's a bad idea. Saying,
if you get there and it doesn't work out, like, what if you get there and it's really mad and it attacks you? I don't want you to die.
Let's not risk it. Let's just all move forward.
Can I cast an illusion?
While you guys have been talking about this, the sound of the rustling and, like, the, like, something big is coming towards you.
Oh, okay.
And it's getting much louder and it sounds much closer.
Can I create an illusion?
Of what?
Of an ursipede.
Have you seen an ursipede in your life?
No, but I'm just kind of based on Shilia's picture.
And the dog.
And the dog. Uh-huh. I want to make an illusion of it and put it in front of us. Maybe a female one.
Okay.
A cute one.
A cutie.
So you're imagining what a female ursipede monstrosity would look like.
And I want it in front of us.
It's
between us and the rustling that's approaching.
It's an ursipede with a bow. In
it. Just one. And lipstick.
See him. Extra eyelash.
Yes. Bare face with big lipstick eyelash. Smeared on his snout. Oh, that's
like
so
the
sad.
Claws are like a little shiny. They're not.
So I'm going to have you roll for this because you've never seen it.
Okay.
So this is sort of like an artistic thing almost.
Oh, you're very artistic.
Well, I am a bard.
So you could always get a regular one and use your disguise kit.
This is going to be an intelligence check. You're kind of logicking out what this you think this looks like.
Are you sure it's not a charm?
No, it's not.
Okay.
Three. It looks... like if you made a three-dimensional version of Shalee's picture. You want to hold it up for the camera again?
Just in case anyone forgot. This guy here.
It's like if you imagine, like, in virtual reality, those drawing, virtual reality drawing programs.
The line drawing.
It's like you made, like, a sketch of your idea in, but
it's
3D.
It's like it's still confused.
Harold and the Purple Crayon here.
So as this is happening, this appears in front of you. And there's getting the sound of whatever is charging towards you is getting much louder. And Kalto kind of like stares at the illusion and says, like, "What? What is that?"
It's an ursipede. I thought you would recognize it more than anyone.
Oh God. And with that, as he says, "Oh God," through the trees, the front of a bear that's very large bursts through, and it's looks like the front half of a polar bear, but you guys see as it's coming through the trees, it's like a train that's coming because it's like, imagine a bear is coming around a corner, but it's not, the body's not stopping.
And the people are getting on and off.
And the people are getting on and off.
It's like a food.
And these legs are tight together, but they're like shuffling.
Think it might be the ursipede.
And it kind of like all of a sudden rears up a little right in front of you. And imagine, you know how bears will stand up to intimidate things?
Yes.
Imagine a bear standing up, but it's another, so it's probably like 15 feet tall.
Wow.
And now the bear's front arms come up, but then it's also got arms coming in front of it.
God.
All and with razor sharp claws.
Yeah, and it just goes.
Jesus, what did it say?
And Kalto goes, "Oh no." And it attacks you.
No! Why? No! Why? Wait a minute! Whoa, we didn't get a chance to deal with it! Hold a minute! No!
You can try to cast something. Yeah. This bear is mad.
You put it to sleep.
Or I could put it on disguise.
The bear's attacking first. The bear gets to attack first. When you get your turn, you can try these.
Okay. The bear gets to attack first?
Yeah. It was barreling in after.
Barreling?
Yeah, but I was there. I listened to the whole thing.
Which camera do I wink at?
Is that long enough? We get that wink? We get that wink, everybody? Good, we got the wink. Okay, so the ursipede. Now tell me when you guys are saying, so who was like the forefront? seemed like you were, because you were thinking about dashing out.
That's right, I have the largest body, too.
Yeah.
But we have the illusion in front.
It doesn't care. Honestly, this thing is mad. So the illusion's still up, and I will say this. It actually gets multi-attacks, because it's got so many.
Why?
So mad
at Kalto.
its like lower limbs, and it doesn't use them super dexterously. Like, they're a bit clumsy.
Like a bear.
It makes two wide swipes at the illusion first.
Oh, good.
And of course, they go right through it. And it pretty much, even though it's like enraged, it can't tell that that is an illusion. But the first two went through there.
Okay.
Then another one kind of goes after you. Another one of the claws.
Yeah, right.
And it misses you. And then
can I do anything? No.
Not yet. And then with its mouth, it kind of like gnashes at you.
Oh, Jesus.
I gnash right back.
And that one also misses.
Phew. Okay.
Now it is your turn. And we're just going to go down the line here.
Okay.
And Kalto will go after you.
Oh, Kalto, you should be at the front. You created
this. You did this.
This is your Kalto problem.
Coward.
Can we pick up Kalto and throw him in there?
Oh, then we'll get our age.
Oh, God. Well, I can always look like him and forge the paperwork.
What are we doing?
I know, you're being attacked. Oh.
Your turn, Steve Computer.
Steve.
What do I do?
Well, what do you want to do?
Oh, well, doesn't she? Wait, what?
But it attacked me twice, and then it's going.
Oh, I'm responding to.
So it just had its turn. Now, because we're in a fight, we're gonna go. Sorry, I'm getting a message from the prison. Okay. Basically, now that we're in a fight, we're gonna go more like turn by turn.
Okay.
Just to like keep things.
Oh, I see.
So now the Ursipede just took its turn.
Uh-huh. Okay.
And I see.
Now
it missed. And it missed.
Yeah.
Gotcha.
So now it's Steve Computer's turn.
Okay.
What do you guys?
I can just do one thing, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Anything.
I have this bardic inspiration where I can like inspire you guys through stirring words.
No, don't.
No,
do that.
We don't need
that. Don't do that. Please don't do that. We don't want that. We don't want that.
I have a lute.
Oh my god. How did we get teamed up with this guy?
I have candles. I'll speak with it.
You're trying to. You're casting speak with animals.
Yes.
For 10 minutes.
So you cast that.
I don't have to talk with it for 10 minutes.
No, you don't
talk with it however long.
But so you cast that, so you can speak with an animal now.
Okay.
So remember, you've cast one of your red spells in with speak with animal earlier. You guys each casted one of your level one spells.
Okay.
So you can say something to it now. I'll let you do that also.
Okay. Calm down. Hold up. Just stop it.
Can we give him any advice about what he's saying?
Well, you don't understand what he's saying.
Right. Oh, so we're just...
I'm just like... let's talk through this. We can get you mushrooms. We can get you gold. We can get you whey. Whatever you want. Just sip this potion.
Okay. So you'll hear its response when it's his turn.
Okay.
Okay.
Oh, so I wait through the...
Yeah.
Oh,
also, consider, like, these rounds, like, where everybody's taking a turn, every one of these we get through is, like, 6 seconds.
Okay.
This is all happening very quickly.
Okay.
Okay.
All right. So now it's your turn.
Oh.
I think that wasn't effective. Sorry.
I wish I could have told you what to say.
Okay, so I'm going to... So you're going to talk to it. I am going to... Oh my god. Oh my god. No, I don't want a bear that's on fire. That's no good. I don't want that to happen. Crap. What's resistance do?
I have to touch it? No, I'm not gonna touch a bear.
Oh, you have to touch it.
I don't want to touch it. No, I'm not gonna. I guess I could do friendship, but then it can't understand me and I can't understand it. We'll just like each other. That could help.
It lasts a whole day.
It lasts all day? Oh my God, yes. For the rest of the day, I'm friends with animals. Good. Yeah, I'm gonna cast my animal friendship spell.
Did you just hear that?
No. Hear what?
When you did that, there was like a tingling.
Hear what, sound. Mary?
Huh?
Will that do so that if we just say it? Spell? If we just say spell or cast, it will do that?
No.
Someone's doing it.
Spell?
No, you didn't.
Not you. All right, so you're casting animal friendship on
Animal
me?
Friendship.
Okay.
And so I know this is my last of my two spell slots. I accept that, and I take with what happens.
Okay.
What will happen?
Baby. Come on, baby.
Okay. Do I have so I have to roll?
Oh yeah, sorry.
Do I have to roll? Do I have to roll?
No, he no. rolls to save me instead. Oh no.
Oh,
your spell save is 13? Yeah. It did not work.
Oh
shoot.
God.
He
How
saved.
How smart is he?
If he was smart, he wouldn't have actually had to make the save.
Yeah.
However, he rolled a 17.
So crap.
So it just didn't work.
It just
right?
didn't yeah. work, and okay. there goes my spell.
Okay.
We're such
That's
pacifists.
Okay. You still,
well,
you still
I'm
have
done
these.
With these. These are no more.
I will tell you this.
Uh-huh.
I'll tell you this. It did.
Upset
There's
him.
A certain thing he can do because he is rampaging that yeah. it'll like. Pacify him a tiny bit just in the fact that he's not like going berserk on you guys a little bit.
Okay.
Now Mary, it's
okay.
Your turn.
I think sleep, right?
Yeah.
I'm gonna I would cast a sleep spell.
Okay.
There it is.
And so for sleep. Oh boy. So for sleep, here's what you're gonna do.
I have to roll for this?
You roll
He's gonna
your
be like,
d8. You're gonna roll your d8 5 times.
D8.
Whoa. Sleeping pills.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
Which one is that?
It'll be
this
like
one?
Dying if somebody took sleep
no,
well.
It's fine. And I'll tell you this, because it's pacified a little, uh-huh. I'm gonna give you...
Why is it pacified?
Because I tried to
oh,
make
the
it try.
Yeah. Hold on one sec. Sorry, I'm... figuring out some math in my head.
I don't have time. The bear is
just 6 seconds.
You're gonna get to roll twice as many on the sleep thing. So you're gonna roll 10d8.
Okay.
Okay.
And okay.
Because pass fine. And you're gonna add those all up. So I'll help.
Okay.
Yeah. So go ahead and tell me what you roll as you roll them.
You got this. 6. Eight. Six. Six. That's pretty good. How many is that? Eight.
Oh, you are rolling incredibly. That's 6 so far. 3.
Jesus.
Okay. 7.
7.
6. 6.
Oh, 6. This is insane.
And then how many more?
You are at 9, so one more.
4. Okay.
Really
okay.
good.
Okay.
So
okay.
basically, the way the sleep works is, in order to put an animal to sleep, you have to have rolled more than how many total hit points it has.
Jesus.
Oh
it's so gonna have a lot.
It does have a lot, so let's add this up.
You did such a good job,
Thank
though.
You,
really
you rolled
Thank
so
you.
Well.
Thank
really
you, guys.
So this is now just me having to add up a bunch
math,
of stuff.
Math. The exciting part.
Comes out to 5,900.
Comes out to 1.5 million.
Here's the thing.
What is it?
If this was not a polar bear, you would have put it to sleep.
What's wrong with everyone? Why would...
I'm sorry. Where on earth do polar bears have Dungeons & Dragons specific strength? They're real. They're real bears.
powers.
In the monster manual.
So what power does it have?
It's a lot. It's basically the different types of bears they can vote for you to be. A polar bear is huge, so it has more hit points than like a smaller bear. I'm so sorry.
But don't I do it a little bit? Does I get a little sleepy?
It gets a little drowsy.
Okay.
You said she rolled insane.
Yeah, you were like,
you said,
this is insane.
And
yeah.
I was like, this is.
Here's the thing. Normally, that spell wouldn't have, as written, that spell wouldn't have mathematically had a chance of. You were so close. I'm
how
so
close?
Sorry.
How far away?
You were very close.
I'll like
tell
one?
You, I'll tell you later on.
Oh,
okay, so.
Okay,
you
so it's
didn't
a little drowsy, though,
yeah,
now.
It goes
drowsy and friendly.
and it's trying to attack now, right?
Now it's Kelto's turn.
No. Great.
Kalto.
Come on, Kalto.
Come on. You haven't done
You're
anything.
A bear wizard.
You haven't pulled your weight.
Do something
so
specific.
Kind of like waves his hand, and he's like mumbling something under his breath. And along with that, it like, I'll tell you this, you guys sort of did what he already did. It sort of like seems a bit pacified. Yeah, it's like, it comes down, and I'll tell you this, it comes down off of its raised up.
Okay.
And it's down on its all.
Oh.
I was going to say all fours, but
all
it doesn't.
Hundreds.
On its hundreds.
All hundreds again, and it's like shaking its head a little.
Oh.
And Kelto is like, seems to be helping with that.
What is he doing, though?
He's casting a spell.
But what?
What spell?
You don't know.
You can't even tell us?
You don't know what a bear wizard casts?
Guys. We can't fight.
That's right. You're right.
So Kelto does that,
you're
and
so
the bear... The bear comes up and he, instead of attacking right away, he starts kind of like coming further out, and it's like he's snaking around you.
Oh, why can't
Is he surrounding
snake?
Us?
Okay.
Well, the first thing he seems...
I'd rather you say bear-a-beating than snake.
So he comes around, and the first thing he does is, on one end, he seems to be trying to encircle you. And constrict you.
Oh, no.
Getting snaked.
I hate this.
However, you're able to, like, push him off so he's not able to, like, fully get around you.
Stronger than the average.
And one claw, basically, on, like, his... So now you are at, like, his midsection. You're not even close to his head anymore.
Okay,
and
great.
One of the side ones tries to just reach out and swipe at you.
Okay, yeah, right. Oh. Good luck.
And it just catches you.
Yeah, but.
On like your flank.
Yeah, but.
Oh, your flank.
But I, this
flank.
Is a bit, but I'm doing a bit. I'm like, oh, he got me. But
oh,
he
the
didn't.
Flank.
Your flank.
And he does two damage.
Oh.
And so I've got a little flesh wound.
Yeah.
Great.
So take two damage off from your knife.
How many flanks
okay.
do
oh,
we
you're
have?
Doing okay.
How many flanks?
She's got two? Four.
Yeah. He also, another one, actually this one would try to hit you.
Oh, shit.
But that misses. And he didn't respond to you yet. So he's doing this first.
I ask you a question, you attack my friends, and then you talk to me?
What a dick move.
What an asshole recipe.
Another arm goes towards... Kelto.
Oh,
no.
Oh,
whatever.
Phew. You're
really. If he dies, though, we'll be stuck here.
You know.
Oh, no, he's trying
you
to constrict you. And then one other arm goes after you since he couldn't constrict
No. Where did a bear learn to constrict?
I mean, it's got a long body.
Around.
It's like,
yeah, but why did it? Why does it know it can do that?
And then, so.
Just this.
The mouth goes towards you and. Because you guys don't hear this, you can't understand it. And as far as you can tell, it's very strange. When it responds, it almost sounds like it's fighting with itself.
Oh,
and
God.
All you really, the sense you get from it is the closest thing to a sentence you receive could be described as a feeling of, what am I?
Oh, no. Oh, no.
Okay.
Oh,
so
God.
It, what I said worked.
It just seems insane.
It's just insane. Okay.
But it's your turn again.
Okay.
Okay.
Where near am I? Where to its body?
So it was kind of trying to curve around you.
Yeah.
And so you're kind of like on the outside of that curving near its front part still.
Near its front part. So I'm like right up by its face, right?
I mean, you're not super close because you didn't like approach it to do a attack or anything.
But it talked to me.
Well, yeah, but it doesn't have to be right next to you to talk to you.
I see. Okay.
But you can keep talking to it, right? This
if
last.
You want.
I see. Okay. Can well, who has the potion?
I do.
You have the potion. Are we close?
The bear is kind of like its long body is like in between you.
Oh. Okay. So
imagine it when it was coming through, it came in between you and then circled back around Shalia.
I see. Okay. So I'd like to create an illusion and a spectacular show for the bear that distracts it to off to a side. And I don't know if I can do this all in one, but I'd be like, Shalia, the potion. And then ideally she would throw it to me and then I would throw it in its mouth.
You're gonna have to describe to me what this illusion you want.
Yeah, what's the show?
And also, for minor illusion, don't forget that it is a minor illusion. Yeah. So, like, you can create a sound.
I created Hamilton. With the original cast.
I'd like to shift.
You can't see that anymore.
Lin-Manuel.
So, and also, you can create an image. You can create an image of an object no larger than 5 feet cubed. The image can't create sound, light, smell, or any other sensory effect, and no physical interaction can happen with it.
So,
or a sound.
Okay, so I want to create a big bee beehive.
A big beehive.
Because they like honey.
Uh-huh.
But it's right. A polar bear. No! The beehive was already made!
An image of a huge beehive hanging from a tree in front of the bear.
Yeah.
Wait, what were you gonna say?
It's fine. I wasn't picturing the tree, but yeah.
Okay, I just assumed it was hanging from a tree. That
works. That works.
Okay, so there's no sound coming from it. Bees, but
you're gonna
like,
see it.
Yeah.
Yeah, and the bear, yeah.
So, and then are you gonna, I'll let you say something too.
I'm like, Shalia, the potion, quickly.
Okay. So that's your turn.
yelled, Shalia, the potion. I'm gonna reach in my backpack and gingerly throw the potion.
Okay, do a dexterity check.
Oh,
and you're doing it to
gingerly,
Steve.
Gingerly throw it to Steve computer.
Mm-hmm.
Gingerly. Okay, I rolled 11 plus 2, so 13.
13? Yeah, that's enough. You were waiting to catch it, so that's like enough. Yeah.
Okay.
Great toss!
Thank you!
But that's gonna be your turn.
That's I understand.
Can I ask what its intelligence is, or no? That's all a secret.
It's a secret. I will say it's enraged, confused, and an animal, so its intelligence is low.
Oh, shoot. Okay.
It just happened to roll very well against that animal friendship.
Okay. I don't want that one. Okay, I think what I'm going to do. Okay. So I can make it laugh. It'll open its mouth.
Oh, that's great.
But I think it has to have intelligence. It has to have like a higher intelligence.
Yeah.
So, and then, but I could do a magic missile. And then, I'm at its center, so I can.
Getting it to open its mouth is a great idea. I feel like none of this matters. Tavlin's just gonna deal with it.
Tavlin?
What's his name?
Calto?
Calto, sorry.
Maybe I should do this one. But that'll just make him more mad.
What, how much? It has to be smart to laugh?
Or I could create a bonfire, and that'll distract it probably more than the bee. And I can, and then I save this.
It might burn down the whole forest.
I think I don't know how to build a bonfire.
I guess we'll keep it contained.
As long as it doesn't get bigger than like a small area, I think I can.
All right.
Snuff it out if it's a small campfire.
Okay.
But so I don't know what the
bonfire fills a 5-foot cube. Oh, a 5-foot cube, okay. Any creature in the bonfire space when you cast a spell must succeed on a dexterity saving throw.
You can basically start a fire under something.
And it's not very dexterous. So wait, but do I want to do that?
Do you want to start a fire under a
I don't need to light a fire. Yeah. Don't need to light a fire.
Also, though, you're like part horse. Can you jump on it or something?
Yeah, can I jump on it and like fuck it or something?
You're naked, though.
I am naked.
I mount the bear. Oh, your boobs are out. Oh my god.
It loves boobs.
Is this weird like tits?
Yeah. Roll for tits.
Roll for tits, please. I really see how good they are. I should try the laughter thing. But it's intelligent. Yeah, I don't know.
It's
I don't
a beast.
Wait, yeah. It's a beast. It wouldn't. Can't make a beast laugh.
Okay. You're so funny though.
But who knows?
Jennifer Love Hewitt is funny.
Yeah.
Jennifer could make a beast.
Okay,
laugh.
I think I feel like I don't know what to do. What do you guys think I should do?
Do you have any like what are
I'll say,
do
you see? You can do whatever you want. You might want to like not use up your last spell slot until you get a little more information on what you're fighting.
You can like kick it or hit it.
Yeah. Yeah, maybe. Oh, but I don't want to turn its head away from.
Also, guys, I'm going to tell you this. If you eventually, like, lower a creature's hit points to zero, you can choose that, oh, we're knocking it out instead of killing it out. Mm-hmm.
But it has a lot of hit points, though.
Yes.
But did I get some of them in the. Did I get.
You weren't trying to hurt it, though. Sleep doesn't take away hit points.
It's damn, just... man.
By the way, don't forget now that you have the potion that it'll just turn into a bunch of bears.
Oh, that's true.
That sounds way more
like
difficult.
I've been keeping that in mind, but now that's on you, man.
Oh, no.
Okay, this is what I'm going to do. I'm at its middle. So I this is what I'm going to do.
Such a bigger
I'm not
problem.
Gonna, I don't want to waste a turn, but I feel like I'm just going to, like...
Go home.
I'm gonna just slowly back away.
Back away. I'm just gonna go up to it. This is what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna go up to it. I have 50 feet of hempen rope.
Okay.
I'm gonna tie it around the middle so I create a kind of leash. So. And what that'll do is if we lose it, I can hang on to it and.
I don't think losing it's our biggest problem.
I'm going to tell you this. You're going to have to roll the CD, because remember, it's got a ridiculous amount of arms down there that have been trying to attack you.
Okay, sure.
So if you
want to
try and get that around that.
We'll be careful.
Yeah, let's do a... Treat it like you're attacking it, but you're not. You're just trying to tie it around, so but we'll do it with dexterity. Yeah.
Okay, here we go. Come on, baby, come on. 14 plus 2 is 16.
Yeah, you're able to get the rope around and, like, get around, like, the kind of flailing arms. Because, like I said, the arms are, like, very... A bear is not used to having this many arms, so they're kind of, like...
All over the place. All over the place. And so I'm... I got the leash on!
Yeah! Good job!
Now we won't lose it.
You created a beehive! None of us are doing well.
Now it's Kelto's turn, and he again is like focusing all his energy on whatever spell he's casting, to just try and like keep this beast at least somewhat like normal bear level and not berserking bear level.
Yeah.
Okay. And he is still like casting that. Okay.
Okay.
And now it's the Ursipede's turn.
It's the Ursipede's turn.
His. So first, let's see how he feels about that.
The beehive.
He's gonna love it.
And I'll tell you this, he doesn't even notice that you put that rope
right,
on.
Right, exactly. That's I didn't
good.
Want him to.
That's good. Yeah. Thank God.
Secret rope.
Didn't want him to, I just wanted to have it.
What's your spell save? Oh, it's right there. 14?
Where? Oh, yeah.
This bear is so stupid, but is rolling so well, he is not fooled by the beehive.
Oh, no.
What does he think it is?
He doesn't hear bees, so he like is just ignoring it.
That was my last hope.
And so he
weapons
tries to circle around.
You have a sword and
Shalia
attack.
Again.
Okay.
Still is not able to.
Yes.
But then tries to bite at you.
No! What? Two things? Why does the bear get to do two things?
And snaps at you, because he has multi-attacks.
What did he get?
He snaps at you, but it's like that, and it misses you.
Oh, good.
What?
Good.
Yeah, haven't you ever had a bear snap at you, Mary?
Yeah.
You know, and then the seal goes, right back at it.
I deserve that. So one of the side arms takes another swipe at you.
Okay, yeah, right.
Misses.
Of course it does.
Another one takes a swipe at you.
Fudge.
That.
I don't like the way you're pausing.
Does hit.
No!
Does it kill me?
No. But it does two damage.
Oh, two damage. Two.
How many damages?
You're a flesh wound. You're
okay. How many flanks do I have?
You only have a two flank.
Another one hits Caldo. Or tries to hit
Caldo.
Oops.
Just know that you deserve this. You did this to the bear.
Oh, yep. That's Caldo.
Good.
Okay. Caldo gets knocked, and like whatever spell he's trying to hold up, kind of like if he loses his concentration, he kind of gets knocked by the bear's arm. Oh! That's what it sounds like when he gets hit.
Thank you for doing the sound.
Thank you. I was having trouble picturing
it.
Well, just so like you can imagine what's happening with him.
Oh! Yeah, got it.
Okay, so now what?
Now we get to.
Now it is your turn.
Can we use the restroom? I saw the 5:30.
Yeah. We're gonna take a quick break because we've had
specific
bathroom requests. Oh, you just want to use the restroom in game?
No.
You want to go off?
No.
Don't you dare! No.
The potion.
Steve's computer goes off behind a tree in the forest. So he can just use a quick bathroom.
How much strength
do I need? We're gonna take a quick bathroom break. Are we putting up the loot vote now, Will? Let's do that. If you want to vote for, at the end of this adventure, who you think should get the one piece of loot out of these people.
Oh, not
if they manage to live, you can go to jash.com/play to vote on that right now and keep watching the stream there. We're going to take a quick break, and then we'll be right back and see how this fight ends.
Stay tuned.
Go to the bathroom.
I'm so sorry.
You monster.
I've had too many problems.
Thank you.
Hey guys, welcome back to Aristocrats. We are here in the middle of a fight with an Ursipede with Mary Holland, Shalia Evans, and Zach Bornstein. Welcome back, guys.
You're fighting
a huge monstrosity of a bear. Mm-hmm.
But thankfully, he let us go use the bathroom.
He did let you go use the restroom.
It's very comforting.
Oh, take your time.
Steve Computer just got back from wandering into the woods to go behind a tree.
I thought, okay.
Okay, so now it's your turn. What are you gonna do?
Okay, can I still speak with it?
Yeah.
Okay, can I ask you something? What's something you would want to talk about?
What he would want to talk about?
Yeah.
I mean, your character would not know that.
Oh, I see.
About a rampaging ursipede.
So I know it's having self-identity issues. It said, who am I? So I'm going to say, like, let's talk about who you are. And then when it goes to open its mouth to talk about who it is, I'm going to chuck the potion into its throat.
So we'll say you're readying an action. So what that basically means is instead of doing something on your turn, you're kind of, it's sort of like setting up, like, when this happens, I'm going to do this.
Bless you.
So you want to ready yourself to, as soon as it opens his mouth to respond,
yeah,
you try to throw a potion into it.
Down its throat.
Okay.
Okay.
That's a good idea.
Thank you.
All right. So you're readying that. So that's your turn, just getting ready to do that. Shalia.
Or and saying the, you know, asking what, who, like, let's talk about who you are.
So, just to clarify, the thing I do is going to happen before that.
Yes.
Okay, so poisoning the bear, maybe. Well, does it have to drink the potion for it to work? Or can it just be poured on the bear? On the ursipede, excuse me.
Kalto had said earlier when he gave you that it needed to be ingested.
I guess we could always hold its mouth and do the dog medicine.
Like when it eats chocolate?
Yeah, just hold it close and massage its throat until it's gone. Because I kind of want to calm it the hell down by poisoning it, but I don't know if that's how poison works. I'm gonna poison it. I'm gonna poison spray the ursipede.
Okay. So he has to save against it.
Yeah.
And your spell save is 13.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, he does not. So that roll your damage for that. Mm. Roll a puff of poison in the ursipede's face.
Just spat on it.
I rolled a 9.
Oh no, that's
no, wrong one.
Wrong die. It's on the
as if I would have
on the poison spray. Yeah, it says to... you're doing
I see.
How much damage?
D12.
12. The D12 is the one that says. Yeah.
Okay, so never mind what just happened. Five. Okay, and then.
So five damage.
Five damage.
So it takes. Great. All right. Mary?
Huh? What does it do?
What happened?
Wait a minute.
What did that do?
It did five damage.
Yeah, but how many damage?
What is that? Oh, we don't know.
It has more than 60, though, because the average of your rolls was more than 6, and you rolled it 10 times.
Hey. Well.
It's
someone
the math.
Okay, so this is what I'm going to do. This is what I'm going to do. Here we go. This is it. I am going to Blade Ward.
Ooh.
So that I can't get hurt by his little claws.
Good.
Can I do that?
Yeah. Blade Ward's gonna make it so that it's basically you have resistance. So basically if he does it hit you, it'll do damage, but it'll do half damage.
Okay, that's good.
But yeah.
Great. I'm interested in protecting myself and not furthering our cause.
Cool. So you have Blade Ward until the end of your next turn.
You got flanked. That's okay.
You're bleeding.
So now it's Kelto's turn, and he just got hit. Oh, so he kind of like backs away a little. And he's like, I'm not gonna be able to calm it this time. I need a moment to recast the spell. Please try to distract it from me. And he kind of like recomposes himself and takes a step back and starts casting again.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
And then the Ursipede, now that that is not being cast, whatever Kelto is doing, he seems more savage somehow. And he just gets that, and he's coming after you guys again. First, his response, what was the thing, what did you say?
I said, let's talk about you, or I know who you are.
Let's talk about who you are.
Yeah. Yeah. He said, what am I? Oh, I said, yeah. Let's talk about what you are, mm-hmm. or something like that.
So what you see is like, as it starts becoming enraged again, Kelto, because of the lack of Kelto's spell, it, instead of responding, like you get the sense from it, like almost more of an emotional reaction of like just confusion. But instead of saying anything, it lets out a roar and its mouth goes wide open as it roars. And so you readied the thing, so you can do a dexterity check to throw it into its mouth.
Come on, dexterity.
Come on.
Okay, what do I need to do?
Roll a 20 and add your dexterity modifier.
Oh my god. Four.
What's your dexterity modifier?
Plus three.
Seven?
Please.
So you throw it.
Oh, Jesus.
And it's roaring. And this glass vial goes right past the bear's mouth.
What's the matter with you?
I'm sorry, I'm weak. All I know how to do is entertain.
And it lands, so it goes past the bear, past your other side, and lands in the bushes.
Oh, so it's safe.
It doesn't break.
Okay.
That's good.
Well, hold on, let me see.
That's a seven?
Okay, it just barely doesn't break.
Okay.
I rolled a two right there. If it had been a one, it would have broke. And it lands in like a bush, so it doesn't break.
It went past me.
It's like, it's not like within arm's distance from where you are, but it's pretty close.
Okay.
But it does certainly does not go in the bear.
Does not go in the bear's mouth.
Can I try throwing it again?
No, because now it's the bear's turn after it finishes roaring. And its arms just all take swings
off. No.
It's just lashing out at everybody now. So we'll do you first. Okay. Yep, it's gonna hit you. With its arm.
And half, right?
For three damage, but that's half, so only one. Good.
And I laugh in his face.
Okay. Well,
just kidding. That was a joke. That was a general love. That was a joke.
Next one goes after Shalia. And that. Okay. Yours is it, that one misses.
Okay.
Good Steve job. Computer.
Mm-hmm.
Also misses you.
Good.
And lastly, Kelto. So Kelto moved away. But the back end of it that's still coming, and it's just now, it's curled up around that. You're just starting to see, like, maybe where the back end of it is. And it's like, if you imagine you guys are here at the back end and Kelto had moved off this way, the back end starts curving over towards Kelto so it can also swing at him.
And there's miles of poop coming
out. Just spraying out the back of it.
Specifically 18 miles.
Yeah.
Okay. And that lasts... arm misses Kelto. Now, it is your turn again.
Okay. That was really my big idea.
You can still talk to it.
Yeah.
Okay.
Right? How long
like,
time
like
is?
10 minutes. I can get to open it
10 minutes, so.
Each of these is 6 seconds, right?
Yeah, so I think you're still fine for.
What else?
How
I
long?
Do?
Oh. How long does it say it goes for?
I
can't find it for some reason. Speak with animals. 10 minutes, yeah, it's still going. It'll probably go this whole fight. You also don't have to talk with it. It seems fairly distraught and out of its mind.
Yeah, it's just a way to get it to open its mouth.
Mm-hmm.
All right, I'm gonna go for the potion.
Okay.
I'm gonna go pick it out of the brush.
So you're gonna go around the front and try to get over to it?
No, I'll go around the back.
It's gonna take more than one turn to go
around. I'll go around the front.
Yeah.
What?
I'm near it.
Oh, you are?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
But
I won't do that.
You have swords and shit, man.
Okay. I'm gonna
do something useful.
I'm passive. Hey, I made a beehive.
You made a beehive.
God damn it. Okay. I'm gonna take out my my dagger and go throw it in its eye.
Okay.
Oh boy.
So roll your attack. Roll your d20. You're gonna add 5 to that.
20.
Ooh, great.
Natural 20?
No,
15.
Oh, 20.
So
burn the potion.
You're gonna roll your 1d4. It's the triangle die. And add 3 to whatever you get.
6.
6? So you throw a dagger and it like slices right. It doesn't go directly through its eye, but it like goes like.
Does it blind that eye?
It definitely injures it.
Oh no.
And it kind of. So now, Shalia, it's your turn.
Uh-huh. I'm gonna mark down
that you, because the dagger kind of went off past it, so mark down that you only have one dagger now.
Oh, I have 2 daggers?
I think you had 2 originally, right?
I have a rapier and a dagger.
Oh no, you only had that one, so you don't have your dagger right now. You could probably find it after the fight, if you're still alive. Shalia?
Yeah, I'm gonna run for the potion. Before it gets stomped on or anything.
Okay. Go for it. You want to get it?
Yeah.
So let's say this. You're right next to the bear.
Yeah.
To be able to, like, get away from it in a fashion where it's not going to be able to, like, snap or bite at you while your back's turned, you're going to have to, like, kind of, like, carefully back away.
Okay, so
I'm probably going to take your whole turn to get there and get the potion.
That's fine. We need that potion so we can fight multiple bears.
Get a bit away from it and get the potion.
So we have a much larger problem on our hands.
I don't know if I really
want
to use that potion.
So you have the potion again.
Great.
Mary.
Okay, now this says charm a person. Does it have to be a humanoid?
Yes.
Okay, and I can't make a bear laugh, so I guess I'm going to.
What kind of comedian are you?
Spellbook.
I mean, at this point, things are
getting desperate. Right? I think I have to. I could kick it to like get its head towards me, and then I could call to you to throw me the thing.
Uh-huh.
Or what I can do, I'll create 3 glowing balls of magical force, and I'm gonna, cause I'm like positioned near its like middle-ish. So I'm gonna aim those for its back half.
Okay.
So it'll hopefully like get its head around to me.
Okay.
Cause it'll distract it.
Okay, cool. So with Magic Missile, you don't even have to roll for it. It just automatically hits. And so you are going to roll 3 of them. You're gonna roll the 1d4. Just three.
Okay, cool.
So the triangle die, the 1d4.
And that one? And how do I read this?
Whatever is, so roll it once. Mm-hmm. This will be 1 of your 3. That's a 2.
Okay, just for whatever's on top of it.
So it's 2 plus 1. So the first does 3 damage. Roll it again.
Okay.
Oh, okay.
Okay.
3 again, so 6 total.
Okay.
And then 1 more. 3, so you do 9 damage to it.
Mm. Pretty good.
Okay.
That's great.
And the bear, So that's you do, and it does kind of swing around and look back.
Okay, and yeah.
What were you gonna say?
Okay, and can I call it there?
Sure, you can yell out.
Okay, give me the thing.
Okay.
So the bear, Kelto, actually, it's his turn. So he's able to like reestablish his set, and you can see the bear seems to like it's not going quite as berserk again.
Okay.
It's calmed down a little.
It's calming the bear.
It's still angry. It's still confused. But it's not going quite as nuts with its attacks.
Okay.
So the bear, that's what Kelto does. The bear.
Yeah, we know.
The bear is turning facing you because it felt that.
Yes.
And so imagine it's coming around Shalia.
Yeah.
Back towards you.
No.
Uh-huh, yeah, yeah.
So now you are almost encircled by bear.
I figured. Oh.
Okay.
So it's
been
coming
there,
towards
done that,
you.
Yes.
And one arm slashes out at you.
Oh, God.
Okay.
Yours is 12. Yeah, and this one hits you.
Under my breasts.
Oh, it does barely. 4 damage.
Oh my god.
I'm surprised.
Where are you at? 7?
7, oh no, oh
you
god.
Have 2, 3? You haven't lost a breast yet.
I never lost.
Something.
It did catch you.
Ow!
Oh no!
I should wear shirts. Okay. So what do I do now? Do I mark this?
So subtract 4 away from that.
So now I have
3. You're getting in trouble.
So comes after you. The body tries to close in around you again, Shalia.
Yep.
And that is 16. Oh, you're lucky you have such good AC. It doesn't get you.
Good air conditioning.
Really good air conditioning.
And then another arm slashes at you, Zach, at Steve Computer. That'll miss. Another arm goes after Kelto again.
Finally.
That one. Yeah, and it smacks Kelto.
Good.
Kind of breaks his.
No, but we need this.
All right.
And it does. Oof. 5 damage.
Uh-oh.
Oh no, Kalto's injured. Oh no. I can make myself look like Kalto.
that's right.
And like then the last arm takes another swing at you.
Okay.
Oh, wow, that's gonna hit.
Oh,
no!
2 damage.
2? Okay.
So now it's back to you.
Okay, so just a quick question, just so I know what I'm seeing. About how big is, like, when its mouth was open, how big was its, like, throat? Like, the hole that I was trying to, like...
I guess it was it was a normal bear throat
like here,
size.
Right?
Definitely smaller than that. I feel like a normal bear throat, like if it was going like that, target for where your throat
right.
was probably like that.
Yeah. So if
and then like this is like where the beginning of the throat is. It probably closes to more like that.
Okay.
I don't know.
So if I threw my bedroll into its throat, it might, because that's probably like plastic or something like that, it might get stuck
it's,
in its...
It's cloth.
Yeah, so it might jam up that hole.
It's plastic.
Sure, you can try that.
But okay. We need it to go down the hole.
No, I want it to get stuck so it suffocates, right?
Yeah. At this point, I want this thing dead. I don't care if it goes back to being other bears.
So are you going to try to throw your bedroll into the bear Ursipede's mouth?
Yes. Well, first I'm going to talk to it. I'm going to say, no, I didn't hear you about...
It's also facing away from you.
Oh, man, this
facing
isn't going to work.
Facing towards Mary.
What part of it am I near?
You're near, like... the midsection that like curved around Shalia. So like if you imagine like if Shalia is here.
Yeah.
And the bear like curved around it like
here.
This.
Yeah.
And you're here.
Oh,
okay. I see.
Okay. Okay. I wanna jump onto it and take my rapier and stab it in the back of the neck.
Okay. So it's moving, so you're gonna have to
Loco.
Consult.
You're gonna have to do a quick dexterity check to get on top of it. But so go ahead and do that.
This will be the greatest show you've ever seen.
That's what you said.
Yeah.
Great. 20. No, it's 7.
7. What's your dexterity?
3.
What's 3? 10?
That?
Yeah, that's enough. You can you're not. It's not quite a show. You kind of like stumble a little and like, but you do get up there.
Mm-hmm.
And you're so you're gonna probably have to keep making acrobatics checks to keep your balance.
Sure.
But for the moment, you're up there and you can stab it.
Okay, I want to stab it in the brainstem.
Well, you're right now. You're more closer to the midsection. You'd have to run up on your next turn to the head.
Okay, I'll do the stab on now in the midsection.
Oh, okay.
So roll an attack.
Okay. 4.
So you try to, but it's still moving towards Jennifer Love Hewitt as that is happening. And so it unbalances you enough that your rapier kind of goes to one side and it doesn't hit my foot.
I'm feeling very impotent.
What I imagine is you, like, doing this heroic thing, lifting the sword above your head and it's too heavy and it holds your
This is gonna be the greatest show of all. Yeah, okay, so I have the potion, but I'm near the middle of the potion and surrounded by bare middle.
Yes.
How far are we?
You could throw it. You're close enough.
We're close enough that we can throw it. And Jennifer Love Hewitt is near
the head.
Yes. Okay. So I'm gonna toss you the potion.
Do a dexterity check.
Which is.
Roll your d20 and add your dexterity modifier.
10, plus 2, so 12.
Yeah, that's enough.
Great.
And I catch it.
Yes. Great. Because you were ready, I know you were talking earlier about wanting her to throw it to you.
Yes, so I was ready for it.
You were ready. That's why it was pretty easy to throw it and catch it. Great, so you throw it. Now it's your turn.
Yes, and now I shimmy to get his attention.
He's looking
There's
at you.
There's blood flying everywhere. Okay, he's looking at me?
Yeah. Okay. Floppy, half remove nipple.
And then is his mouth open?
Its mouth is sort of been open a lot here and there.
Okay. It happens to be open at this moment.
Yeah.
I insist. It's not even a question. I'm like, it's open. And I'm going to throw it in.
Okay. So do a dexterity check.
Okay, come on.
Okay.
Twelve, and then
two.
Plus two, 14.
You throw it into its mouth.
Yes!
Yes!
Wait, there's gonna be so many bears.
There's gonna be so many bears.
So there is a closed glass container in its mouth.
Oh shoot! Should we have undone it?
Is it corked or how is it closed?
Yeah. I mean, it's sealed.
You said it almost broke. It was like one away from breaking.
It was soft. It must have hit a tooth or something.
Right. No, it so think about it this way. It hit it. Didn't break, but it is in its mouth.
Okay,
and
good.
It's a bear.
Okay.
So nothing happens yet.
Okay. Can I just say I love... I'm just thinking back to how we've attacked it. And we've created a beehive. Tried to throw a bedroll in its throat. And it's so funny.
Most heroic adventure.
Tied a rope around its middle just in case.
Trying to get loose.
Yeah, that rope is still just hanging out.
Yeah, it'll come in handy. I know it will.
So now it's Kelzo's turn, and he is trying to now to reestablish
the
contact on that. The Ursipede is now looking very angry again because Kelzo's spell is not at the moment. He's having no. Make it up again.
Right. Actor on its back.
Yeah. Frickin' bard on its back. And it's got this glass thing in its mouth. So the first thing it does is bite down hard.
Oh.
Great. Ooh, good.
Because it's so enraged that it just is, it's going to tear apart anything that is in its mouth. Yeah, and it crushes that glass.
Yeah.
And the contents, the potions of dispel, all come out. Now, some of it sprays to the sides a little bit, but it's very clear that a significant amount of that and glass goes down the Ursipede's throat.
Ouch. Take a week for it to move through.
Yeah, it's going to be passing. It's going to be passing glass for a while.
Passing glass.
And it takes a tiny bit of damage from that glass, too.
As it should.
Yeah.
Science works.
So it swallows a ton of the potion.
Good, I think.
Nothing seems to happen yet.
Right, of course.
Now it swipes at you.
Oh boy, I think I'm almost done for.
No.
No, doesn't quite hit you.
Okay.
Slashes at you again, because you're what's right in front of it. Also just barely doesn't hit.
Oh my god.
One arm hits, goes after, tries to reach up to the thing on its back.
Mm-hmm. It's a thespian?
Yes. And it does not hit you.
Oh, good.
And then the last one, it tries to constrict you again.
Why does it think it's a snake? It's a bear! Do bear stuff!
Oh boy.
Oh no.
It constricts me. This is my.
So, its body was around you and it's arms kept trying to grab you.
No.
But now it got you. And it's like, imagine being surrounded by bear fur and body.
Oh, I'm there.
And now it just closes in on you and starts squeezing. So first off, it does 5 damage.
No. Oh, okay. I'm down to 2.
Okay, you're okay.
And you are grappled, which means you are restrained.
Yeah.
You cannot move, and anything that you... Any attack you make has disadvantage, and any attacks against you have advantage. You can try to escape this, but you'd have to use your turn to try to get out of it. It's basically holding you.
Yeah.
Now, it is your turn.
Okay, so the potion is, like, in its throat?
It swallowed the potion.
Where in it is it? Where in the bear? Where does it need to get inside the bear to work?
You don't know.
How deep into the bear?
I mean, you could ask Kelto.
No, but that would be my turn.
If you yell something out, it's not your turn.
Kelto, quick! How deep into the bear does your potion need to get to work?
He doesn't respond yet until his turn.
Oh, okay.
But you can do something else if you
want. Okay, all right. So we need to make it, like, swallow. Okay, I take all of my
rations. Swallow, just so you know.
It just hasn't worked yet.
It's just not deep enough in. So in my rations, does it... I have a water skin. I run to its head along the top of it, like going like this to its head, and I take my water skin.
So real fast, since you're running along a moving bear centipede,
sure.
You're going to have to do an acrobatics check to keep your balance.
Okay.
So, go ahead and do, that'll be dexterity for you.
I'm gonna get like a 2. 16 plus 3.
So,
you're running along the
and I want to, and the water skin, is it the kind of thing that you can, like you were saying, it's like a canteen that you can squeeze?
Yeah, it's made of animal skin.
Yeah, so I could squeeze it and get the water down into
it. So you're trying to help it wash down the potion of dispel.
Yeah.
You're gonna have to make an attack roll for that because you're basically getting your hand very close to a monstrous bear mouth.
That's fine.
Walk me through. You want to basically like get close to its mouth and squeeze that water.
I guess I'm like on its neck essentially, right? So I want to like lean over its face and squeeze it in.
Okay.
You have to be like on its snout, right? You have to be like perched on its little nose.
Let's make that another dexterity check, just because that's like such a like you're kind of having to like keep your balance while bending over it.
You're so dexterous.
Thank you.
You've got the
really are you?
Okay.
Oh.
What is it?
It's a 3.
Plus 3? 6.
6.
So.
Oh no! What happens?
You miss. So you lean over. However, the bear is moving, and it's so angry right now because Kelto hasn't gotten its spell to pacify it a little back up. It's so angry that when you start leaning over it, the bear just does that like bear head shake thing they do, where like,
yeah,
and it throws you off.
Lucky duck.
So now you're to like Mary's side, to Jennifer Love Hewitt's side. Sorry.
Yes.
Boy, are you getting the show.
You're bleeding.
Bleeding.
Oh my god.
One nipple.
Hey, big boy.
Where do I put my coins?
Roll a 1d4.
A 1d4, yeah. Is this for how much water gets in its mouth?
No, this is for how much damage you take from getting thrown to the ground by a monster.
3.
So you take 3 damage.
Oh, God.
Where are you at?
I'm at 4.
You're at 4. You're still doing better.
Yeah, you are.
Okay. Shalia?
Okay, this isn't a move or anything, but I'm just, like, curious if I really missed an opportunity a while ago. Would a sensor have led me to this bear? What's a sensor? What is a sensor? It's not spelled the way I want it to be.
Oh, it's used to, like, spread incense.
Oh, it's that thing. Just making sure. Okay. I just was like, aw, crap. Is it just a typo and I missed it? No. Okay, so I'm trapped by the bear.
You can try to escape its grapple.
I can try to escape. I can't cast any spells or anything from within the bear's grasp.
You can, but if you're attacking it, you'll have disadvantage.
Okay. Is it gonna keep damaging me the longer I'm in its grasp? How good at wiggling am I?
It's
what is my
be
wiggling?
A...
My wiggling roll.
Ooh, let me just.
Oh man.
Reminding myself. Yeah. So you can try to escape the grapple.
Okay. Yeah, I think I'm useless wrapped up by bear. I'm also so close to death. I could also just set the bear on fire.
Ooh. But you're caught in it.
I know, but I'm gonna go anyway. Should I try to get out? I'll try to get out. I'll try one last ditch effort to save my life before I set the bear on fire. Okay. I'm gonna try to go up and out of the bear, not down and out. Not down and out, because that's where the claws are.
Athletics check.
Okay.
So you're gonna roll, it's strength for you. So roll your d20 and add your strength modifier.
19
nice.
Plus 2!
Woo!
Yes! Yay! Suck it, bear!
Cold, and you squeeze up, so now you're kind
like
of on top.
I'm like,
yeah.
Yeah, just.
So you get out. But that's your turn.
And I'm perched amid the bear's midsection.
Ooh.
Jennifer Love Hewitt.
Just repeat my name.
Okay, so I have 10 torches. Can I throw a torch? No. I'm done with these, I think. Okay, so I could create a bonfire.
Uh-huh.
I don't know what that would do. I could run at it and...
Why do I have an alarm going?
I don't know.
Laundry?
Probably laundry.
You're near its face?
Yeah, I could kick it with my legs. But I feel like we should do, because you're like above the coil, right? Where
yeah.
We could throw something down there and then blow it up.
Oh.
Potentially, ooh. Right?
If you have explosives.
Standing
oh, when I don't, I use mine. Shoot.
Oh, God.
Oh, God.
I have a disguise kit.
Okay, what if... Okay, what if... This is what I do. If I... Okay... I have a quarterstaff, so what if I take my goal is to, like, lodge its mouth open and, like, you know, so it can't close its mouth.
Okay.
No. I want to cast a friend spell. I want it to think I'm cool.
Friends is for humanoids.
I know. Oh. I was hoping I'd catch you off guard.
You're hoping I forgot that the bear wasn't a human?
Okay, I think I want to create... a bonfire,
mm-hmm.
and like right in front of its face, and like.
Great.
Yeah, right? Yeah.
Okay, I'll try that.
Okay, so like right underneath its like front paws and face?
Yeah.
Okay, great. So you do that, and I believe you don't have to roll for that. Yeah, fire just springs up.
Okay. Great.
So you do that, and it's standing in the front in fire.
There it is.
Now it's Kelto's turn, and he finishes casting his spell again.
Oh.
And kind of shouts back out to you and says, like, it's fine, it's so long ago, it takes time to work through its system. It has very long intestines.
You suck, Kelto.
No, but keep weakening it. The weaker it is, the quicker it should be able to take effect.
Okay. And so we can fight a bunch of bears?
I can take care of normal bears
when
they're out.
Oh, no.
You never asked.
You should have offered that information.
We shouldn't have had to ask.
So he does that. The bear is now very upset. It's very hot. At the start of turn, because it starts in this fire, it takes a roll 1d8 for how much... fire damage.
That one?
Oh, wait, I'm sorry, no. It tries to dodge it. And it does not.
Great.
So now you roll your 1d8.
And this is 8.
Yes.
Okay.
6, nice.
Okay.
So you guys also notice, and that happens, the bear, all of its long, its body, it seems like it's rippling.
What?
Ooh, it's gonna break up soon.
Like, you ever see a cat where they like?
Oh yeah, the little bears are trying to get out.
Yeah, like what?
When you see a cat that has a bunch of little cats trying to claw their way out.
What the fuck kind of cats do you have, Mary? No, like, but you know, like when cats like their backs will like spasm a little.
Yes.
Like it's like all around the bear, it's doing that.
Oh no! I'm up there.
And however, it's getting upset again. So it first snaps at you because you're right in front of it.
I think I'm done for.
But it misses you.
Phew.
Okay, good.
An arm tries to reach up at you on top of it.
Oh.
Misses very badly.
Oh.
Another one kind of body like edges over and tries to swipe at you. Misses badly.
Okay.
And one tries to hit Kelto. Flynn does hit Kelto,
Kelto,
of course.
Oh, bummer.
But doesn't.
Oh, bummer.
All right, now it is your turn, Zach.
Okay.
And I know we're running a little late and you have to go soon,
oh,
so.
Oh, I appreciate that. What was I doing?
You got thrown off next to it.
Oh, you're so I'm just like on the ground near its face?
Near, yeah, by Mary and its face in that
front. And it doesn't have the wood stick in its mouth.
No. I didn't want
that. Okay, so I can still speak with animals, right?
Yeah.
If I like talk loud enough, could other animals around hear me?
If there's any around that haven't been scared off by this fight.
Oh, they're probably scared. If I couldn't like summon to be like, birds, attack!
They didn't respond last time.
Yeah, last time I yelled birds, they all left.
Sure, listen, you can absolutely try that.
It sounds ineffective. Okay. What are you at life wise?
Okay, I have,
You're at three?
Oh, three, I'm
okay.
At two.
Oh, three.
Oh, yeah. You're at two? Okay, I'm gonna use my healing word on Shalia.
Oh, that's so sweet.
Thank you.
I like to think that in like if like adventuring so fantasy adventures were real, that when one of the people healed the other one, they do that same thing. Like, that's so sweet.
Thank you.
He is a sensitive soul.
Mm-hmm.
You said healing word?
Yeah.
So you're Shalia, you get back 1d4 plus your ability modifier.
Wait, okay.
Spell ability modifier is 6. So you get back, you roll 1d4.
Which one's the d4? This
triangle.
One?
Triangle. Whatever that is, you get plus that and 6.
It's hard to get it.
So 10.
4.
Up to your maximum.
Oh my gosh! Oh. You're like a superhero.
So I'm back to. You
you're even stronger.
Plus, yeah, I'm full health.
So you're back up to 9.
Oh my gosh,
yeah.
Amazing.
And now it's your turn.
And I'm on top of the bear right now. Okay, so the bear's wiggling around.
Uh-huh.
And I'm in its midsection. Can I take my mace and give it like a real solid whack to the spine?
Yeah.
That's what I want to do.
All right, roll your d20.
Ew. 17.
That's absolutely
plus
gonna hit.
Strength.
Oh yeah.
Oh yeah. 19.
So roll for your mace, you do.
Oh, I do it multiple times?
No, you do damage.
Oh.
So you're gonna roll a d6 and add 2 to it.
Oh, okay. So 6 is.
This cube?
No. It's a normal dice.
Yes.
The dice. two.
4.
Plus, okay.
All right.
What happened?
It's looking, it's shaking more and more.
Great.
That mace hit, it like, it started shuddering and it's like that racked along its body.
Yeah.
And it's still shaking a lot, but it still came together. And you can almost see like at one point, it almost looks like, if you imagine a sheet on its fur skin, if you imagine like a sheet and like another bear face.
Oh, see, that's what I was imagining before. Not crazy.
You mean cats?
Yeah, like when cats are trying to get out of other cats.
Yeah, exactly.
Mary, it is Jennifer Love Hewitt's turn.
Oh, come on, Jen.
Okay, what should Jen do? Jen is going to, what does a quarterstaff do? It's just a big old stick, yeah?
Yeah, it's like, think of the staffs that Little John and Robin Hood fight with.
Yeah.
Does that make sense?
Yep. Okay, I'm going to, because I want to let that bear out. So I'm going to, I'm going to take my 10 torches and I'm going to hold it up to where I saw that bear's face.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to,
You're going to hold torches up to its face?
No. Okay. No, what I'm going to do is I'm going to do my How do we say centaur, but it's centaur? I'm gonna do my centaur kick at its side.
Okay.
What the heck? this is an epic.
Our army has arrived.
Yes, and they just came up over the hills.
Roll your d20 to make a kick.
Seven
plus three.
Okay, 10.
10 just barely hits.
Oh. Well, I do have flesh wounds, so.
Roll a 1d4, and you're going to do that plus one bludgeoning damage with your kick. Are you kicking with your back legs or your front legs?
My back legs.
Yeah, so you turned around, faced your centaur back at its side, and just back kick.
And then
yeah.
I do this.
Yep.
And then roll this.
I'm so sorry, guys. I don't know why these alarms are going off. Three plus one is four.
Four.
So imagine this. This Parapede is shaking all over, and the centaur turns around.
Ursipede
is shaking. Centaur turns around, kicks it, and when that kick lands, it's like there's a explosion, and hundreds of bears just start spilling out everywhere.
But I get out of the way.
Yeah. Just bears are coming out, and they're all confused, and they're running. They're not attacking. It's like all these bears just want to get out of whatever. And it's like the Parapede is magically shrinking, and the arms are disappearing, and other bears are moving out. It's a bears. Your brain almost can't comprehend the spatial aspects of what you're seeing. Mm-hmm. But by the end, you're standing in this field with around 100 bears. Of various types, a lot of polar bears, and you can see Kalto is sort of like pacifying all of them now, mm-hmm. and he seems to be like now sending them back off to places, the Parapede itself is, or Ursipede itself is gone.
No more Ursipede.
Wow.
And we made it through without anybody dying.
Shockingly, you did.
Wow.
And as Kelvin does this, because I know, Zach, I'm so sorry, you have to go.
No, you're
late.
Good. Don't worry.
We're going to wrap this up faster, because luckily, these contracts also have a magic aspect. When you complete them to the letter of the contract, there's a little image of a treasure chest.
Oh, right.
A Tavlin's thing. Mm. And a portal to a pocket dimension opens up, and you can get your reward from that.
Okay.
Cool. He also comes over and says, like, thank you so much. Whew. Could not imagine what would have happened if that thing kept rampaging.
Yeah.
Very glad we got these normal bears back. I promise I'm not going to be teleporting a ton of bears into the same place proper precautions in the future.
Yeah.
You should have your funding rescinded.
No. I don't want your without proper precautions. I want you to look me in the eyes and say, I will not try to bring a bunch of bears to one specific spot.
Fine.
Thank you.
And Kalto, you owe me a nipple.
That'll regrow, won't it?
No.
I don't know centaur.
Oh, I don't know.
Do you know anybody that works at your at your office that does nipple magic?
That was one of the
Can you give a recommendation? Yeah.
Are you looking for a mammomancer?
Yes, a mammomancer.
Mammomancer.
We need a mammomancer.
My kind of mammomancer.
So, you guys each get.
Oh.
Why are you bringing this Google info on if you
told him to Google
on?
It.
I didn't do it, I just put it up.
Can you move that so I can see who gets the loot? So Kelto comes out and he gives you each pull out of the contract 15 gold each.
Ooh. Thank you.
You managed to revert the Ursipede instead of killing it.
Mm-hmm.
And Kelto comes up and says, thank you so much. And also, thank you so much for not killing this. Because of that, I'd like to give you something. Since you seem to be friends of bears everywhere, especially you, who did such a good job in that and didn't want to kill it. Here, and he gives you a wand. This is a wand of Ursamancy.
Oh.
You can use this to summon a brown bear to your aid.
Oh my god.
Fancy.
That's nice.
Cool. Thank you.
Thank you.
Does it work everywhere?
Anywhere that a bear would normally be.
Huh?
What?
So you gotta be in the woods or something?
Or a zoo?
Okay, well, it's still very nice, thank you.
If you use it in a city, it will call a bear to you, but the bear would be coming from somewhere, so the bear would have to run to
take a while.
Okay, so it would be rude to summon it
somewhere it wouldn't already be.
Yes.
Thank you. That's wonderful.
Thank you so much for your work.
Can I ask you one question, Kalto?
Yes.
I don't know if you've maybe know or not, but do you know how old Betsy actually is?
Who's Betsy?
Oh, never mind.
Never mind. Never mind.
It's all right.
I don't know who that is. I'm sure we'll have plenty of time to talk about it as we head back to the city, though.
Where the Ursa Man
is. Should I get us a bear to give us a ride back?
Oh.
Is that
what you want to use
no.
that for?
No, never mind, never mind. I'll keep it for something
it's
more.
It's got one charge.
Oh.
Oh.
No, then no, I can walk.
Single bear use.
Let's get you to a titty doctor.
Thank you so much.
Off to the titty doctor.
Mamamancer.
We are going to wrap this up. Zach, I know you have to go. I'm so sorry.
Oh, it's okay.
If you want to run out now, I can do the outro now. Because it's, what time is it?
6:30.
I'm sorry. Wait, is that I'm so sorry.
No, go, go, go.
I'm sorry.
We ran late. Zach has to go, so he's going to run out. Guys, thank you so much for watching.
Thank you.
Thank you, everybody, for playing. Bye, Zach.
Bye,
I'm so sorry.
Sorry, we ran a little late this time.
Oh, Steve Computer.
Hey.
Hi, Steve Computer.
Do you need your notes?
Bye, Steve Computer. I'll take that, so you can have it next time.
I'll read your notes.
Aww.
Oh,
everybody
guys, he's hugging everybody.
Getting hugs right now.
I'm gonna cry. What a sweet. What a sweet.
And after he used that healing word to heal you, oh my God.
I know. Guys, I'll send you a bear.
Thank you.
Thank you so much for watching, everybody. Are we gonna? So real fast, can you put up the leveling vote?
Oh yeah.
Oh.
Yeah.
Shalia,
yeah.
This is her second time on the show,
she is
going to make a quick appeal to you guys for you to vote if Shalia should level up to level 2.
Great.
So you have a moment. Go ahead. Talk to this camera. Tell them why Shalia, woodwife of Shalia, deserves to go to level 2.
Guys, I'm appealing to your sense of decency and humanity. As someone who has never gotten to play Dungeons & Dragons before this experience, this is only my second time ever, I do not know what leveling up means. But you're giving me an opportunity to learn, and isn't that what this is about?
It's a good appeal.
Really?
I'll never know if I don't get it.
Well, we're finishing this up. If you want to vote on if Shalia's character should level up, you can go to jash.com/play. The Twitch stream will still be in that window, and you can vote there for if she should level up. Guys, thank you so much. I feel bad that Zach had to run out so he couldn't do this, but if you guys have anything you want to plug...
Oh, Zach wants to plug, like, his Twitter or whatever.
Yeah, probably his Twitter or whatever it is.
Oh, I'm on Twitter.
Zach
he retweets me a lot, so you'll just get more of me. let me play. Watch Guy Code versus Girl Code on MTV2.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, hell yeah.
You want to see a less supportive version of Girl Code. It's just the same advice, but with fighting.
Oh. Cool. Good.
Yeah.
Good plug.
Good plug.
Yep.
You can follow me on Twitter at mholland85 and go check out Mike and Dave Need Wedding Dates.
Yay!
Yay.
Absolutely. I actually don't think I knew that you were in it. That's great.
Oh, yeah.
Surprise.
I can't keep track of what all my friends are in.
Fair.
But no, that's awesome.
Thank you.
Go watch that. Everybody go watch that.
It.
Yeah.
big ol' yes for you leveling up.
Yay!
Next time you come on, Shalia, woodwife of Shalia, will be slightly more powerful.
Oh,
maybe some more spells.
Cool.
Maybe some more abilities.
Do I get to bring my bear wand?
You still get your bear wand.
Yes.
That's
all I care about now.
Guys, so if you want to watch old episodes, you can go to youtube.com/jashplay. If you want to submit an adventure, at the end of the month, we do a user-submitted adventure that someone else gives us the details on. There's a Google Form link on our... in the info section of our Twitch page. You can go there, submit a job for someone to do at Tavlin's Temporium. And we are every Thursday at 3 p.m. Pacific Standard Time. And next week, we won't be doing D&D. I won't be DMing. We're doing a Star Wars 80s RPG episode, and I will actually be playing, which is going to be weird to be on this show and not have the control I have. All of my alarms are on, apparently. Actually, I know why. I took a nap yesterday, and I wanted to wake up at 6, and I didn't.
This is live. Come on.
Oh, boy. Guys, thank you so much for watching. We'll be back next week.